That's why we decided to send you to church, son. Focus on books. Focus on ball. Shit, I didn't have the opportunity to do. But instead, you turning into a little fucking G. What, you the man right now? Is that what it is?
None of us is going to jail, right?
Hey. 4 cops are dead. That's on you, son. 4 people that showed up to save you, Tariq. 4 families are completely ruined because you had to be the man.
Our family's ruined. Why should theirs be any different?
What do you want from me, Tariq? Huh? What do you want from me, boy?
Teach me what motherfucking game goes.
All right, this is the Three Ninjas Podcast. It's anime analysis by African Americans, comic book commentary by Coloreds. Movie reviews for me and you, your mama, your cousin too. As usual, I go by the name of Domino, aka Full Metal Smacker Bitch, aka Womb Raider.
My dingling, I want you to play with my dingling.
This act is over.
Aka the Bulbasaur Ambassador, aka Machoke, used flamethrower, aka Clark Kente Claw, the Dreddy Kruger, Optimus Rhyme, Ghost in a Half Shell, Oscar the Gooch, Space Ghost, Face Killer, Inspector Deku, G.I. Jimbo.
G.I. Jimbo, he's gonna destroy everybody for you and you and you and you.
Akuma Matata, Mansa Mufasa, Tony's little friend, Frank Castlevania, Master Chief Keith, Barry Flanders.
Finally, honey.
We must protect this house!
Ninja Scroll and Chill and R2-D2 Chains. And as always, I am joined by...
S. Jones, a.k.a. Dr. Deuce, a.k.a. Han Solo Cup, a.k.a. Bruce Banner, a.k.a. The Full Metal Alcoholic.
I gotta have a beer!
A. Beyblade, Ava Uzi, Bernie Big Mac.
What in the fuck was that?
Mace Windu Rag.
You know what I got underneath this durag?
What you got on the durag?
Another durag.
Black Lightning. Jason Mimosa.
And also in the motherfucking dojo,
I go by the name Bobby, a.k.a. Darth Hater, a.k.a. the Man of Skill, a.k.a. the Juggernaut.
Yeah, it's the Juggernaut, bitch.
A.k.a. Professor Sex, Mag Negro, Bizarro Rondo, Super Saiyan Brohan, Piccolo Escobar, Bruce Mane, Cloud Stripe, Melanin Manson, Samurai Black, Michael, Get the Strap, Son, Red Jacket,
Gotta be Doctor,
Campaign Poppy, Bobby McFly.
What's wrong, McFly? Chicken?
Nicholas Gage, Bastard Troy.
I am the terror that flaps in the night. I am the stain that can't be rubbed out.
Gee, what a surprise.
Oh man, my ninjas.
Yep. Yep.
What's going on? How we doing?
Hello.
How's your weekend been, Mike?
Pretty good, you know. Can't complain, really do a whole lot, you know. Went out to the bar last night and shit.
Mm-hmm. You know? That's why you're so chillaxed over there with the hoodie on.
Yeah, I'm a little tired.
Hoodie hesh?
Yeah.
Hoodie hesh.
I'm a little tired.
Okay.
I'm not going to lie. I was sleeping.
You sleeping when?
Just now. Rest of my eyes.
All right, my nigga. I need you.
Nah, I'm good, dog. I'm back. I'm
hoodie gang.
Gang.
Hoodie hash, I got you. Baba La.
Shit.
Fuck going on, man? How's your weekend been?
Good night.
Yeah. What you do this weekend?
Went to Hooters.
Hooters
for the first time. That's my first time being there.
At Hooters?
Mm-hmm.
In life?
That Hooters?
Yeah, in life.
I thought you was just... Oh, no.
I've never been to Hooters before.
No, you're just telling me, but... What? Oh, nah, never mind. Not yeah.
You could have swore you'd been there before.
Me too. I could have swore he's like, been there.
I was going to go.
Oh.
I pulled up and I was like, nah, I ain't doing this. So, and it was way too crowded. It was one of those, I think it was...
Spartan Vid or something?
Yeah, when Conor was fighting Khabib. And I was like, it was way too many white people here.
So
I was like, I'm out.
I don't think I've ever been to a good Hooters. Like, I don't think I've ever been to a Hooters.
I was just going to ask you, how was your Hooters experience?
Yeah, how was your Hooters experience for the first one? First time ever.
I see why people go there.
Yeah.
And they do flirt a lot.
Well, that's the job.
And you can tell which ones really like you.
Okay.
Based off of how...
Are they like strippers?
Hmm?
Are they like strippers where they pretend they like you just so they can get tips?
Well, they do that. Like, well, they do that, but then when they do that, you have to write off the checklist. Okay, she's doing way too much in this area.
I don't know. Be careful with that one because that's how niggas get caught up.
Yeah.
Well, she liked me. No, nigga, she's just doing this because she wants that $20.
Oh yeah, that's when you get the That's when you hit them with the checklist. Like, yeah, okay, like, she's supposed to do that, but she's doing
perked
a little too
them
much.
Perk them titties up.
Yeah.
Well, that's how you get the tip.
Now, I ain't really give a fuck about that. I ain't really give a fuck about it. She was just walking around, but...
You relax. You just set the parameters and then overstepped the parameter.
But yeah, my
I'm back.
Boy... my boy worked there, so I was basically eating for free.
Mm.
And like he worked there for a minute. I think I told this on the podcast. He walked out and then they were doing a line where he was about to leave.
They
was
doing
like,
coke on the table.
That's Mike. He cool.
Mike cool.
Yo, he all right.
He all right.
rubbing that shit on their TV. Yo, Mike good. He ain't telling nobody.
Yeah, so he was telling me about these two females that he talked to. And he said he'd just be fucking with them, you know, trying to make them feel special and shit like that. Mm-hmm. And they be hitting on them. And come to find out, he was talking to one of them. And the other one was like, oh, damn, I told her first dibs. He's like, damn, they treat me like a piece of meat. I was like, dude, you living life.
He's living his best about life.
Yeah, so basically, like, he's dark skinned. He looked like the black Jesus, right? And he got a beard and
wait,
shit,
Jesus
but he got
black.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Black History Month. Jesus is black, dog.
Fuck what you doing?
Mesopotamia, yeah, you know, nigga.
He the only nigga I know. You know, the only nigga I know still rocking braids. So he got the braids and shit down to his back.
Oh damn,
got the beard and shit.
Oh, see the beard. The beard do it.
The beard do it to them bitches, man.
Yeah,
they love facial hair.
So he's telling me that. I was like, damn. Mm-hmm. I might switch occupations.
He's like, yo, nah, Bobby. I was like, I could cook chicken, nigga. I could do that.
Nah, Bobby.
That's all Hooters got is chicken.
I love you. I don't want you doing coke.
Yeah.
Stay away from that shit.
Why was wrong with doing coke?
I mean, initially, it is a drug that can kill you, but, you know, if Bobby, he come in here and drop 80 on niggas, I don't give a fuck. Do all the coke you want, nigga.
Have a Kobe game for these niggas? Do what you want, nigga.
That nigga come in here and drop 81 on some coke? Bobby's coke game?
Came through here. Like, you do all the lines you need to do, nigga.
Exactly. Come in here and just shoot him. Yak him.
Oh shit, that's hilarious. Oh
man. So yeah, man.
How was your weekend?
My weekend was cool. I had the weekend off from work, so I just been chilling.
Word.
I just was contemplating and just realized how much I hate my job, because like sitting around and like doing nothing, because when I get these weekends off where I can have off Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Yeah,
and it's rare that I get a chance to like sit down and do nothing, and just like I don't have to host nothing. I ain't got to prepare for a podcast. Yeah. I ain't got to edit some shit. I ain't got to do something for somebody else. It's rare that I could just like sit and watch these shows that everybody be talking about that I be missing.
Yeah.
It was cool just sitting around and just doing nothing.
Yeah.
And we all just need those mental breaks and shit. I think my next weekend break, I think I'm going to take a trip so we can either not do a show or I'm just not going to be here.
All right. We'll
figure it out. It's like a month from now, so don't worry about it.
Okay.
I saw my dad this weekend.
Oh, shit. How'd that go?
Oh,
should we open up again? Here we go.
Nah, like, it wasn't the conversation that I wanted to have, but he happened to come over. He was doing a favor for my sister. You know, he's the only nigga that we know with a pickup truck. I'm telling you, my mom only called this nigga when she need him for something. I was like, yo, you went fishing, bring me some fish, nigga. Yeah. I need your pickup truck, bring me the truck, nigga. Yeah. So my sister bought a bed and he got a pickup truck, so I helped bring it in the house and get it off the truck.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we talked for a little bit. And it was like that awkward, you know.
Don't know really what to say.
Yeah, it was like, you know, the catching up.
So,
it was like, yeah, it was
how
like,
you
so,
doing?
Yeah, how you, yeah, it was like, so.
I'm good.
You still working? I'm like, I'm still working. You still over there? Yeah, you know, been there about 5 years now. Good benefits over there. You know, it is what it is.
Yeah.
Just that awkward, like, damn, nigga.
I don't know you, so I don't know nothing about your life.
Came out your balls, man. You don't know nothing about me.
Hey, shit. My father don't know nothing about me. I had to curse his ass out the last time I speak to him. Looked at him like on some serious shit.
I mean,
shit.
What the fuck?
At least you've seen him more often. I think last time I seen my dad was maybe 3 years ago. Three or four years ago. So, you know, it's that.
Yo, this is like some Sasuke and Naruto shit. No, it really is. Like that shit was really deep. Like it was when Naruto was like, yo, I ain't had no family either, Sasuke. You know, we could, you know, he was like, trying to tell him, like, yo, Naruto, it's not the same. Like, yeah, I knew my family. You never knew your parents, my
nigga. Like, ever.
It hurts more for me because I knew these motherfuckers.
I knew
you ain't know
gone
them.
Now,
so you ain't got no attachment. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah. but like we talked for a little bit, you know, it's that, you know, small talk, or whatever. And then like I asked him if his number was still the same. He said, yeah. I was like, all right, I'm gonna call you soon.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna set that up, you know, sooner than later.
Yeah, it's about to start getting a little. I mean, it was fucking freezing out today.
Yeah,
it's supposed to be getting warmer soon.
And then like it's fun. Well, for me, it's funny seeing like both my parents together and shit.
Yeah.
So they sitting on the couch, they just fucking yucking it up, just talking about shit. my mom and my dad just sitting there talking. I'm just like, listen. I'm like, yo, my dad can still beat if he wanted to. I'm like, yo, this is fucking funny.
I think you always get that privilege. Like, you be going for a minute.
Yo, and then like, then I started seeing shit that like I get from my dad. I was like, oh shit. Like we was walking to the truck. I was like, damn, I walk like that nigga. I was like, damn, man. But yeah, it was cool seeing my dad. Like, all I did was rest this weekend and, you know, chill, got some shit done. I still got to do my goddamn taxes.
Yeah, I ain't do my
shit.
I ain't getting no fucking money back like that, so I don't really
be saying. Yeah, I mean, all my shit going to student loans anyway, but I still got to do them shits, but, you know.
Like, they take your whole thing?
Whole thing. Whole joint.
Yo, get your student loan shit right, nigga.
I can't.
I can't.
I mean, I can, but, yeah, like, I owe a lot.
Well, I mean, yeah, but can't you, like,
readjust us.
Yeah, redo it. So, like, you have to, like, yeah, and start, like, I'm gonna start making payments on it here, dude. I mean, you should maybe,
I mean, I don't know. I gotta talk to somebody.
Yeah, you should, yeah. You should, yeah.
That's why I ain't filed in like a couple of years. I'd be like, I ain't getting shit back, so fuck y'all, dude.
Yeah, but then you don't file it, I fuck you up too.
Yeah, I know. So I gotta, I gotta do all my taxes for like the last like 3-4 years.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I'm wilding. I'm out here.
That's crazy.
All right, nigga, have fun.
Oh, hopefully the government don't listen to this.
I used to have nightmares when I was going to college.
I mean, yo, I shouldn't have went now that I look back on it.
Nigga,
like, the shit I'm doing
I used
now,
to have nightmares for not going to college. I used to wake up and be like, oh, shit, I'm late.
I'm not doing shit. I'm never not doing nothing with my life. But then it's the shit I'm doing now didn't require a college. Even the job I got after college didn't require the degree I got.
Oh, facts. Yeah.
So it was like I could have just skipped all that shit and just went straight to what I'm doing now.
That's what made me feel fine and not going.
Nah, yeah, like, you don't necessarily need college. See, what I'm doing now, I went to school for specifically, but it's a trade.
Yeah.
So like, if you go to school for a trade, that's different. Yeah, and it's taking you to a career path,
right? Yeah.
But just going to college for whatever is not necessary. I mean, I'm not saying if you want to do it, but it's okay if you don't. You can probably find your way through. Like,
yeah, you listening,
without,
kids?
Without
fuck school.
Without,
nigga,
do coke.
Without
nigga,
starting the beginning
Hooters
of your life incurring a lot of debt.
Yeah,
right. Yeah.
Yo, that's important.
That not getting thing your taxes, my nigga. God damn, that's how I get most of my shit.
I mean, he not right. Yeah, my boy just showed me how much money he's getting, like six G's from his taxes.
Yo, for real? Yes.
Yeah, I was like, nigga, I don't know, I don't know what you did, how you did it, but you got to tell me the secret because I don't get nowhere near that.
Nah, but like 1 year I got him, I was good. I got back like 2 G's. I was like, all right, I'm good. I did it the next year, and they took my whole shit. I said, whoa.
Damn,
where's my shit? And then I was like, you know what? I ain't filing taxes for like a while.
That gotta suck.
Just said, fuck it, because like, you know, the times I'd be getting off of work, and I'm like, I don't feel like doing this shit. And then like the time passed, and then it's like, oh, it's a whole new year now. So
yeah, you about to be fucked.
Yeah, about to be fucked up. But you know, it is what it is. I can make money other ways. You know, I'm good right now.
That shit hurt.
But them fees, yeah, them fucking fees gonna hit me.
I'd be hurt.
But as long as I get the shit, I'm getting the shit straight this year. Like, I'm getting all
trying
my
your financials,
all my financials, all my car taxes and shit. I'm trying to get that shit straight so I can, you know, just be out here cool. You know, if y'all take my shit next year when I file taxes, cool. Just take that shit, put it towards my debt, and you know, I'll work that shit off in like what, 15 years or so.
What?
Just have y'all taking my shit.
Yeah, student loans.
Student loans is crazy, nigga.
I'm so glad I didn't go to college.
That's depending on it depends on how much you had to borrow for school.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's set up that you're in debt for a very long time.
That shit is wild.
Unless, like, you'll see the stories where people will be like, I purposely lived fucked up so I could pay my student loans off faster. Like, people will, like, they were like, I see mad stories on the line where they're like, I'm living off ramen and shit. Even though I make more money than that I don't have to do that. But I'm living like this so I can get this fucking debt off my back sooner so then I can live my life without debt.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
I know a dude who went to UConn and then he just ended up being a bus driver. I was like, yo, you could have done that straight out of fucking high school.
Exactly, but we don't know that shit going in.
Man.
So when you don't have guidance like that.
Well, because they tell you the path to success is
you got to go to school and do this and third.
If it's a trade, I understand. If you want to be a doctor, I understand. Lawyer, I understand. But,
if you just gonna fucking paint going walls for 11, you don't need to go to college again.
Right.
You don't. Like, nah, but you don't. But it also, it depends because life is funny and it's fickle. So you might have started out at some point having a different plan and career path and then life happened and you just end up doing something different and then in retrospect, the thing you end up doing, you didn't need the degree for, but
I mean,
you had a plan to do something else, but it didn't work out. Like, so
yeah, I think this needs to be spoken about a lot because even with the trade, you don't really need to go to school. All you have to do is apprentice behind somebody.
Yeah, it depends on what the trade is or what you're going for.
Like, let's say if you're being an electrician or something like that, right? You can easily go to one of these land sharks.
Mm-hmm. Land sharks who own a building be like, oh, we want some cheap labor. Oh, I'll do it. I know how to do it. I've been doing it for years, like following whoever. Like, I do it. I fix that shit. They do that shit all the time.
Yeah.
Damn,
yeah.
Fixing sinks and shit. Like,
plumbers, rent free. All that stuff.
I mean, when you know better, you do better.
Yeah.
I didn't know better.
Yeah. So we telling y'all's nails.
And that's the other part of the scam. It's like they fucking hit you when you're fucking 17 years old.
You have to go to school. You gotta go to school.
Yeah. You gotta go to school. You gotta have your life together. You gotta know what the fuck you wanna do for the rest of your life. And like, college is the thing. Go to college and fucking spend $60,000 a year.
And then they had that little seminar. You feel like shit when you didn't sign up.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I used to have nightmares for a while.
I
didn't go to college. I ain't shit. Ah!
Not necessarily. Because you don't have the debt.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
all I want is my degrees, man.
Yeah, degrees,
my
man.
My degrees.
Yeah. My dad died. All I have is his degrees to keep me warm. But nah. If I'd have known I wanted to get into media, I'd have went straight to media.
Or went to school for that.
Went to school straight for that. Yeah. But I mean, I feel like the path that I've been on, I met some really cool people. So it's some shit I would trade, some shit I wouldn't. But, I guess.
But it's different now than back then,
it's
right?
It's way different now.
Like you go to college for networking. Mm-hmm. Right now, you can just do that shit online.
Yeah. I mean, that's all college is for you to network and then, barely pass and graduate and shit. But it's more so you go for connections.
Yeah.
Connections, and then it just looks good on
your resume. Yeah. Like, hey, you went to school for something. So I having a fucking associate degree that's just sitting there.
Yeah. But doing nothing with it. It shows jobs that you can commit to something.
Yeah,
focus back in
08.
Yeah. Well, not even just what the skills were, but it shows them like you spent four years.
Yeah,
2 years
or
dedicating your time and effort to achieving something. So that means you can focus and probably get work done. So that's.
And even with that, it's like who you know.
Oh, yeah.
That too, definitely.
That's way more important for a lot of things, right. Especially for jobs, than probably who you know than what you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's life. Life 101, nigga.
Listen
with the three ninjas.
Yeah. Right?
Now you know.
Real life with the three ninjas. So, I'll keep y'all updated on what the fuck's going on. But SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, Spotify, YouTube, iHeartRadio, wherever the fuck you get your podcast, we are there. ThreeNinjasPodcast@gmail.com for any comments, questions, or concerns. If you want your question answered, the Ask a Ninja segment, you can reach us there. That is ThreeNinjasPodcast@gmail.com. Also, don't forget to visit our website, 3ninjaspodcast.com, where you can sign up for our newsletter. You can sign up for our Patreon there. Also, I'm going to try to remember to say this shit every show. Please go to iTunes and rate and review the podcast. Follow us on Spotify. Subscribe to us on YouTube and any other place that you listen to our voices and watch our content. Hoodie Hesh.
Yes, sir.
What we got, man?
Cue the song up just in case.
Oh, because I know one of them bitches
is very long. And I cannot read.
Another one is very poorly written. Boom, got it.
All right.
Let me make sure my volume is good. Let me see.
Your levels is good.
All right, we good. We out here.
That's the wrong song.
No, I was just playing.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I got it.
Okay. Butterfly in
I just making sure. Okay. Anyway, so this question, we're going to start with this one. This question comes from a young James Watts. Shout out to this nigga. His question goes, dear ninjas, you already know who it is. James Watts, aka No Neck, All Disrespect. I know, that's pretty funny. Quick question. How do you feel about people that's trying to be a part of your wave of fun and success when they never returned a favor, never hit you up when they was doing their thing? Basically, you was riding for them, but they never was riding for you in the same sense. But now they trying to be around again. P.S. Even worse.
Butterfly in the sky.
Even
I can
worse
go twice
when you do the
high.
Most for them and they putting in the work for others. So basically, how do you feel about people doing only want to come around when you're being successful, I guess, or only not really fucking with you the same way that you fuck with them?
You know what?
Nobody like you till everybody like you. Right? That comes with the territory, you know? So a lot of niggas that, we talked about this before, how we got friends that don't support us right now.
Yeah.
But I bet you once we get like a deal or blow up or something happen, like, yo, I always been fucking with the Three Ninjas podcast, nigga. Those are my niggas. I've been knowing her since she was blah, blah. I know this nigga down for me. Nah, nigga. When the last time you shared my shit? When the last time you listened to my shit?
Yeah.
What the fuck we talk about on episode 75?
Yeah.
Was you there? You wasn't there, nigga.
You wasn't with me shooting in the gym?
Yeah. And that was a Kobe episode, too.
Like Kevin. Yeah. You remember when, not you. Okay. It was when Cam when Cam was on the Domino Effect podcast, he said the realest shit. He said, you know, in order for people to respect you here, you got to leave and come back as God.
Yeah. You know, so we don't get love in your hometown or whatever, because we see that all too often where you got to leave. Get popping somewhere else, and then you come back like, y'all always been fucking with that nigga. Yeah. Like, nah, that's never the case. But, you know, it comes with the territory. That means you're doing something right, though.
Yeah.
People see your ascension.
Yeah, and it's nothing to get, like, angry about. Sometimes you just got to look at it. It's just some human shit.
Nah,
yeah,
you can be angry about it, nigga.
Well, no, you can't.
Nah, because it's like, yo, it's hard to explain your vision to people, and then when people write you off, it's kind of, well, for me, it's hard not to hold a grudge. So it was like, yo, when I'm showing you this shit, I believe in this shit. And then when you see it maybe a year or two from now or whatever the time frame is, you see it start doing something, then you want to hop on a bandwagon. I got a problem with that because I tried to involve you from jump. So I can hold a grudge. I can feel some type of way. Eat a dick. Don't come back around.
It's like when you was on the Courage Convos and y'all was kind of talking about that shit a little bit.
Yeah. Mm.
I was listening. We was in me and Bobby were outside listening when y'all talking about that shit. And I was like, I agree with her. Like, her point was like, if you're my friend, you should share my shit and all that shit. It's like, I feel a way about it, but I don't feel as strong. Like, I'm not losing sleep.
I'm not losing sleep
about or anything like that. But I do feel like if we're friends and if you fuck with me, like, if you was doing, like, I feel like if you was doing something similar, I would try.
That's
like,
different.
I would try to support you.
That's different.
So, but just because you're not doing it doesn't mean, why can't you? Sharing something on Facebook is like the laziest, weakest, like not thought. There's no thought involved.
It take you 2 seconds to hit a button.
Yeah. And then and then it's on top of that. Like, you share other things on Facebook.
Right. Yeah.
Like, you share memes all day.
Yeah.
So it's like, you can't take the 3 seconds it takes to share my thing on Facebook, but you'll share some shit about fucking some dumb shit.
Yeah, but that's anybody that's trying to start a business or you know, have something going for themselves. Yeah. Like, you see that all the time.
Yeah. So that's my take on it, but I don't take it personal. I'm like, all right, fine, whatever. People are people. Humans are humans.
Yeah.
It's whatever. Yeah, it sucks. Yeah, I'd be like, I feel like if the roles were reversed, I would try to be more supportive. Like, even when you was doing all the other shit, before we started doing this thing, I was like, I'll share, I'll fucking comment. Like, and it doesn't nothing for me. I'm just trying to support.
I don't want to have to ask nobody for my support.
Yeah, me neither.
It was like, yo, if you see me post some, this nigga doing this, I could share it. You know, I fuck with that nigga.
Exactly.
Like, it's that simple.
That's it. Yeah.
If I got to ask you to support me and we supposedly fuck with each other,
then
that's not real support. That's fake to me. Like, like I said, I'm not losing sleep, but do feel some type of way a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, you
don't nobody owe you shit at the end of the day.
No, nothing. They owe you nothing. But you clock it. Like you
you're like,
of course you pick a mental note. Like, okay, I know what you ain't doing.
The note is in it.
Yeah, the note's there, nigga.
Yeah, but it's not going away now.
Saved. It's in the cloud.
Yeah, you're not. It's saved and it's not going away, but I'm not going to let it affect the way I treat other people. Or be funny to people about it, but I do.
Yeah.
But you think about
it. Yeah, you know who's clocking your shit. Damn, I think I've been hurt a lot. Like, because I look at this shit completely different. When y'all was having that conversation, I was like, damn, I really don't give a fuck who does or not. Because I had my own dad tell me that the shit that I wanted to do, I wasn't going to do it. Mm. Like, my first passion was drawing, right?
That hit different.
Yeah, see? Yep, see? God damn. See? So ever since then, I'm just like, you know what? Fuck it. I don't need nobody's support. I just do it myself.
Yo, what's up with 2020? We open up late.
Yo, we
open it up late. God
damn. I'll peel his onion back. Nigga.
Shit, nigga. Like, there's a reason why I act the way I act. Like, so now, since I'm kind of glad he did do that, because I was always this kid when I was younger that I can do whatever the fuck I want to do. Like, I can do that. If it's something that just seems impossible, feel like I could do that shit.
Yeah.
Like, I remember one time I had one of my friends, I used to go in his house, he used to build computers and shit, right? And he was hacking this PlayStation. And you know, with the bootlegs, you got to put the spring in it and take it out a certain time.
Yeah.
He tried to switch out this Dragon Ball Z game, right? It was Dragon Ball Legends or something like that. He tried to
the screen.
He tried to switch it out. He couldn't get it. He was like, fuck it, I can't do it. I said, let me try. He was like, if I can do it, you can't do it. All right, so I'm looking at it and I'm timing it.
Yeah.
So normally it would be like this would stop and then it'll spin up again, right? Mm-hmm. And that's where you're supposed to switch it. But he was doing it, wasn't working.
Yeah.
I was like, wait, hold up. All right, so if it stops, spins again, I'm going to wait and see if it stops again. It stopped, spin, and then stopped again, like, then I switched it.
Yeah.
And the shit came on. He's like, I got it working. He's like, I ain't think it'll go work. I was like, then fuck you.
Suck my dick, nigga.
Believe in me.
trying to think if I ever had somebody tell me I wasn't gonna be shit. Matter of fact, you know the shit that rappers be talking about. Yo, my teacher said I wasn't gonna never be shit.
My teacher was at the opposite.
Yeah. I really had a teacher said I wasn't gonna be shit.
Oh, where?
Yeah,
high school.
Yeah, high school. Yeah. My 11th grade English teacher told me I wasn't gonna be shit.
Damn.
Because I was acting up. And
wait, 11th grade?
11th grade English teacher Miss Gisson Tanner told me I wasn't gonna be shit.
You the dick, Mrs. Gisson.
Told me I wasn't gonna be shit, and I kind of took that to heart. I was like, damn, yo, a fucking adult just told me I wasn't gonna be shit. I was like, I just can't go through this adolescent stage of not knowing shit and not knowing my dad and not having no guidance and shit. I'm like, yeah, I'm lost right now, bitch.
Yeah.
Supposed to be helping me.
Supposed to guide me.
Guide me, ho.
Yeah.
But,
Oh, another thing I wanted to say, too, is because he's talking about doing stuff for people.
Mm-hmm.
Don't ever do anything for someone expecting them to do stuff for you in return. Do it because it's something because you care about that person and you want to do it. And then that's it. And you got to take it at that. Because doing stuff and expecting people to reciprocate the type of shit that you do for them, you're going to fucking drive yourself insane.
Yeah.
So if you do stuff for somebody and they don't do shit for you, then you just got to be okay with that. And it's going to suck a little bit because it's like, damn, I'm out here caring and shit. Mm-hmm. And you fucking just don't give a fuck. But don't do things expecting to get things in return because then you're not doing it for the right reasons. Right. And then you'll end up feeling extra bad about it.
Yeah.
Do it because you care about the person. You want to help them out. You want to do stuff for them. And then take it for what it is when it's your turn and you need help, but they don't show up. But like, fuck it, whatever.
Yeah, that's a hard lesson I learned very late in life that, you know, you do shit for people and you expect that same thing in return and it's just not reciprocated. Kind of feel like, damn, I did this shit out the goodness of my heart. I would hope that this person I did this shit for, or even my friend, would return the favor and then they just don't. I'm like,
not gonna happen.
Yeah, but then you just keep getting burned and burned and burned. So you're like, all right, so one day I got to stop doing this shit. So. Yeah.
But don't let it turn you cynical like that. Or
yeah, don't let it.
Be a good person because it's what you want to do.
Yeah, but it's
not
hard
because you think
the world is full
you get
of
a
assholes.
Reward for it. Yeah,
it's really hard to be a good person.
It's not though.
It's not what it is. Because like, you know, when someone does something good for you or to you and it's unexpected, you be like, damn, there are some good people out here. But it's like that one bad apple. You be like, yo, fuck humans.
Yeah,
fuck people. Yeah. Fuck everybody. Fuck you. Just fuck them. Yeah. Like, I'm just looking out for me and that's it. But it's really easy to get jaded. You know, it's really hard to, I guess,
is it a
get out of that
mindset. Do you think it's a confidence thing?
A confidence thing?
Yeah. Do you really think it's a confidence thing?
I don't think it's a confidence
thing. You don't want to go on that road alone?
It's just a morale thing to me. It's like, you know, I feel like I'm a genuinely good person. I just do stuff out the goodness of my heart. But everyone don't think like you.
Yeah, well,
everyone don't feel
sometimes.
The same. I mean, that's why some people, you know, do shit by themselves. They don't ask for help just because they've been burned so many fucking times. So it's like, why am I going to continue to ask for help or try to involve somebody in some shit when every time this shit has happened in the past that, you know, I've been shit on.
Damn, that's the whole Kanye. Because he said some shit that hit me. He was like, he was in a rap. I forgot what the fuck was. He was like, he said, I could be by myself and enjoy the company. Mm-hmm. It was that Boost Mobile shit. Remember that? Where you at? The whole shit? Yeah. That's what I try to like.
Because if nobody got you, you know you got
you. Yeah, that's why I try to push in my daughter like real early. Like, stop doubting yourself. Just do the shit. Mm-hmm. Like, I remember one time she was doing some shit with some blocks or some shit like that. She, you know, kids sometimes. I can't do
they
it.
Did,
I
said,
yes,
up.
You can. Relax. You're crying too much.
Yeah.
She do it then. You know, there you go.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, my daughter got that shit from me too. It was like, she be playing a game. Like, I can't do it. I was like, relax. Maybe turn the game off.
Come back.
Come back to it.
Yeah.
Bet you'll get it. And it's like, daddy, I did it. I was like, bitch. What you talking about, nigga?
Yeah,
mama mentality.
This is my baby.
My baby. Got that shit, didn't you? Look
out
at
here
you.
Beating zombies' ass.
Look at you, champion now.
Shit.
But nah, man, don't be expecting shit from people.
No.
Do shit out the goodness of your heart. And, you know, if they hop on your wave, then, you know, that means you're just doing something right. And, you know, take it in stride. Take it how you want. You know, just act accordingly and know, you know, this person can't be trusted.
Yeah. And I think that's really one of the reasons why people fall off and don't want to do what they're supposed to do. That's why it's a select few who actually succeed. Because they like, I ain't getting support. It ain't happening. Like, nigga.
Yeah,
because you got to do it yourself.
Even with podcasting, this shit is very fickle.
Yeah. And it's, I don't know, it's like, if I can't even get my friends to do it, then who's going to do it?
Who's going
to
do it?
You don't do it.
No, but I'm saying, like,
you
can see how it gets into your mind. It's like,
yeah, but this...
I can't get a nigga who I've known since I was 2 to fucking repost something I'm doing. How am I going to get strangers to fucking do it?
Yeah, but this podcast is a testament to that.
Yeah,
no, I'm just talking about in general.
Yeah, in general, always, but it's hard to see the light at the end of the tunnel when you've been, you know,
there's always somebody
so
who
much.
There's always somebody in the world who thinks like you. That's why I say what I say sometimes. Y'all think it's crazy. But no. Like, I know it's somebody who went through that shit.
I could probably count how many niggas think like Bobby.
Nigga, next Bobby. Thing I know, I get a DM like, yo, I was doing the same thing.
I need you to understand that just because other niggas think it, don't mean it ain't crazy.
it don't mean it's a good idea.
It's still crazy.
It's still wild.
It's your life. I'm not...
The crazy deal works.
You can think you think your thoughts, and that's awesome because that's why the show works. But it's also crazy. Don't think just because another nigga think the same way, it ain't crazy.
It ain't crazy, yeah.
There's mad niggas who think the earth is flat right now.
Okay, that's some
mad niggas that
I know. It's not apples or oranges, but you know, what I mean.
That's something else.
Yeah. All them fucking Arabian niggas that be blowing up themselves and shit, thinking they going to heaven to get 100 virgins and shit. They all got the same mindset.
Yeah, that's something else.
Niggas, I'm doing what the fuck they say?
Nope.
Praise I'm doing
Allah, and just boom boom.
What?
Then they boom boom.
Oh, I thought you said zoom zoom. Like, nah. Like
Yo, they did it in fucking Watchmen.
They did. Oh,
he killed what's the name? Parents.
Yeah.
And then he went boom boom.
But he was top.
Well, okay, so kamikaze soldier, not just like the fucking the Middle Easters, but
yeah,
you know.
Good. All right. Well, yeah. let's change the narrative of that statement on this a little bit.
But I mean, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, it's a little racist. When you scream Allah Akbar and then go boom boom.
Yeah.
It's a little racist.
I mean, but fine.
It's a little bit.
But I know, yeah. You're fine. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Absolutely right.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying the people that do it more than
the people that the news tells us does it more.
It's usually radicals.
You're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah. It's not just stereotype of whole people.
You are absolutely 100% right.
Like, I see no difference in mass shooters. Like, they shoot a lot of people, then just shoot themselves. It's the same thing. You're just not using a bomb. You're using
machine guns. I mean, sometimes they don't.
Yeah,
but,
no,
I think all these motherfuckers kill themselves.
Most of them try to get killed.
Or either
they try to kill them, either they'll kill themselves.
Fucking Boston bomber, he tried to kill himself.
Yeah, but they caught that nigga, right?
Yeah, they caught that nigga before he actually blew himself up.
Was he in a boat?
No.
I think the brother, one of them was in a boat.
Wait, one of them was dead.
Yeah, one of them's dead, yeah.
Okay, so yeah, he was in a boat. I think they caught that nigga in a boat. Yeah. I'm fairly certain. Don't call me.
Yeah, he was
in a boat. I thought they caught that nigga in somebody's backyard or something.
Yeah, in a boat.
Oh, in a boat. Oh, yeah, I thought you meant all that.
Nah, not
in
the
boat.
It was somebody's boat.
Yeah, nigga was in a boat.
Yeah, just be a good person. Be the best person you can try to be.
Be the best you.
And then don't worry about if other people is doing what you feel like is the same level as you.
Right.
Can't drive yourself.
Or matter of fact, how about you find people who's doing the same exact shit you're doing? That'll make
or find better. People who do reciprocate.
Yeah.
There's both those options. But if you can't find the people, don't drive yourself crazy because the other people ain't really fucking with you.
Yeah. Right.
The way you want, that you way that you feel they should.
Right.
All right. This next question comes from Alex. Alex goes,
why do you have that accent?
I don't know. I have no idea. My brain don't. It just do things.
Okay.
Yo, what up, my ninjas? It's Alex, a.k.a. the Dreadlock Predator, a.k.a. your friendly neighborhood St. Louisianan, a.k.a. Drogon used Gallic Gun. got a question for you guys. If you could live in any video game world, what would it be? And how long do you think you would survive? Love the show. Love the show. Hopefully I get this in on time. And oh yeah, Domino, rest in peace to the legend Kobe, but fuck the Lakers, Clipper Nation all day. LOL.
See, I'm not going to shit on the Clippers because there was a point in time where someone from our town actually played for the Clippers, so I do have respect for the Clippers. Yeah, Charles Smith.
I don't know who that is, but cool.
Yeah.
I don't watch sports.
I don't know what it is.
But, if I was to live in a video game world, which one would I want to live in and how long do I think I'd survive?
Well, it depends on, let's see. If you go like something cool.
If I go cool,
like Little Big Planet, you'll survive forever.
Yeah.
Survive
forever. Animal Crossing, yeah.
Animal Crossing, yeah. Be a little villager, just fucking dig trees up and plant peaches and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And fight that raccoon nigga who I owe mad money to.
Right. Animal Crossing, maybe Pokemon.
Oh, Pokemon be cool, yeah.
The Pokemon universe and not like Pokemon in this real world where we'll just be having like random fires and we'll be cooking magic carps and shit.
That's just scary, dude.
I want to say Leisure Suit Larry, but I catch like three types of AIDS and I don't want that.
Wow.
Leisure Suit Larry.
A whole bunch of wow.
The hoodlum in me wants to live in Grand Theft.
Yeah, I was thinking Grand Theft, but then I'm like, I'm not gonna survive.
I'm not. Yeah. I give it maybe 5 hours.
I'm gonna be a random stranger who get clapped. Yeah, I was bored.
I'm gonna be a random stranger that get fucking ran over by a 13-year-old that just want to joyride and shoot shit up, 5-star, 6-star shit.
Why you going through the God mode? You
yo yeah, oh yeah. Oh. Nah, yo, the shit where you get the mad guns.
all guns.
back. Yo, I used to love doing that shit in the middle of the street and not having no gun in my hand.
I mean, being in Mario's world might be cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you get... Okay, so how many humans are in actual Mario? Would you have to be a Toad, or would you actually be like Mario, Luigi, or the Princess? Because as far as I know, there's only like 5 or 6 humans.
Yeah, it's like two pussies. So it's like,
wow.
What? It's like 2 girls. You can actually.
It just 2 humans. Yeah. Is Daisy
Peach? Luigi. Ironically,
yeah, Daisy and Peach.
You saying Luigi don't be knocking one of them Yoshis out?
The Yoshis?
I don't know. Fucking Goomba or something. I don't know. Nigga, pick one.
I mean,
pick a weird animal creature. That's still the fucking joke applies, nigga.
I just want to know where Bowser Kids came from. That's all I want to know, really.
Peach. That's their mom, nigga. I don't give a fuck what you tell me. You can't keep letting a nigga kidnap you. You like that.
What?
Yeah, she like that. They ain't a relationship, and she just be cheating with Mario, but he be lying to that nigga.
Somewhere in the world, that's problematic.
Oh, no, definitely facts.
Shit. Yeah. You ever rewatched Popeye?
Oh, Olive Oil
getting kidnapped by Bluto? Oh, yeah. She was a bitch, yo. She liked that nigga. Nah, she liked that nigga. And Popeye get mad, like, and then this nigga just got upset. I'm like, yo, fuck that bitch, man.
Yo, is Bluto like black or something?
Nah.
Like Dominican or something?
He might be Dominican.
Nah, because she white. So maybe she's like, she really want to be with that nigga, but because of the times, she got pretend to be with the white nigga. So he got to pretend to kidnap her every couple of weeks. But really, they just in the cabin in the woods fucking.
This is a sick nigga. That nigga said, yo, because of the time, we can't be together.
I'm just saying.
Holy shit.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
So you think Popeye's racist?
Maybe not Popeye, but maybe Olive Oil's family. Maybe they don't want her to be with a nigga. So she got to be with the white sailor nigga.
Didn't they have a baby?
No, that was like... What? I don't know whose kid that was.
Popeye's nephew or some shit.
He was like his nephew or some shit like that.
What? I don't know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I don't know.
That nigga said Bluto was Dominican.
Or something.
And they couldn't be together.
They couldn't be together.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, what's the next question? I'm tired of shit. I'm tired of you.
What? Yo, tell me that nigga ain't fucking Dominican or something.
Let me look up Bluto. He's called Bluto.
B-L-U-T-O.
B-L-O Bluto.
Bluto. I'm gonna even Pokemon that.
Bluto. Watch a nigga be like Ecuadorian or some shit. Watch a nigga be like
what, Brazilian?
Something. He gonna be something not white, and then she'll be like, oh, that makes sense.
He might be Mexican.
That's a white man.
Yeah, he probably is. I'm just saying. I'm just talking shit.
Bluto the cartoon. Okay, go ahead.
All right. So this one's gonna be a long one. This one comes from Sierra Jones. Shout out to Sierra.
Oh, snap.
Ooh, with the lady.
She said, hey ninjas. I just wanted to let you know that I really enjoyed the Kopi podcast. Not that you all don't support each other in every podcast. It was just extremely heartwarming to hear you be vulnerable with one another and get your emotions out.
Oh.
Eliminating that whole black men are aggressive, hostile, and not supportive to cry thing, which I already knew wasn't true. After listening to that podcast, it really got me thinking about my black male students. I hope you guys didn't forget... LOL, that I teach the little churns. Eighth graders. I definitely bond with them, and it's cool that I help eliminate the stereotype that a beautiful, nerdy black woman with natural hair can relate, not be weird, and quote, Key Glock. I had to learn, y'all. I don't know what Key Glock is.
Key Glock?
Key Glock. Yeah, that's your Key Glock. Okay, I just want to make sure I read that right, because you know I'm stupid.
Name of the podcast.
Key Glock. Key Glock. However, my question is, if you could tell your eighth grade self anything.
Also a rapper.
Key Glock? I didn't know who that was either. I got to educate myself too.
Yeah.
However, my question is, if you could tell your eighth grade self anything to motivate them in the future, what would it be? I ask this question because, unfortunately, I have young black men in my classroom that currently can be pushed into doing the wrong things. He definitely reaches out and asks me questions, etc., and I definitely talk with him. I'm his mama, y'all. However, I want to know if you guys could add in some extra. Love y'all. Sierra from North Kaka. Lackey.
Kaka Lackey.
I messed up. Or NPS hash. I might have to do another psychoanalysis. I don't know what that means. I have no idea what
told
that
you
means.
An empty shell of a nigga.
Promise you I'm not.
What would I tell my eighth grade self?
I guess basically to motivate them and maybe lead them to not be in a you know,
stay down the wrong. State more of my opinions.
Yeah.
That's hard as fucking eighth grade.
So many things.
Yeah, so many things I would tell my 12, 13-year-old self. yeah, listen to yourself and listen to that little voice in your head. Most of your fears is shit that you made up in your head and don't actually exist. Fears are not real, but danger is real. So, you know, that whole thing. Don't try to fit in.
Yep.
Be you, and the right people will gravitate towards you.
Yep.
Yeah. Most of them niggas that's your friends right now is not your friends.
Yeah. Nope. It's hard to tell kids that shit.
It's very difficult.
Yeah. Hard as fuck. They ain't gonna see it.
That's their whole life.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, it's easier. It's easy for us to say it now, having learned that, even though I'm sure if I went back far enough, I'm sure when my parents probably said that, or
that's not your friend,
right? Or gave you that time, or just like these, it don't matter the way you think it matters.
Yeah, right.
So I'm telling y'all right now, the minute y'all motherfuckers get out of school in general, niggas acting different.
Yeah.
they know you now, like, oh, all right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, nigga.
None of that shit matters.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Try to be yourself as much as you can be. Don't be afraid, like he's saying, like, even if maybe you feel like you don't have a lot of friends, it's going to be all right. Do the thing that you want to do, and you'll find people who fuck with the shit that you want to fuck with. Right. Don't worry about what other motherfuckers got to say if they make fun of you. Or like, especially if we're talking like just nerdy shit in general, like if it's because of that, even though it's more acceptable now. Mm. But like, okay, you read comic books and people make fun of you, fuck them.
I like this. Be you, and the right people will gravitate towards you.
Yeah.
I think the internet kind of is the gift to the curse to that.
Yeah, because you can find people online.
Yeah. But at the same time, you can be influenced by bad people.
True. Right, you can.
It ain't like what we... See, damn, we had it hard, but we had to focus on people in our vicinity. Y'all niggas got everybody across seas and shit.
We got the world at our fingertips.
I got all that.
At a certain point, it was like we only had like the people that we saw in our neighborhood, the people at our school, and that was basically it.
Yeah.
We thought that was the world.
Yeah. Save money.
Save money.
Aggressively.
Yes.
Aggressively.
Aggressively. Because that's important. Save your fucking money.
Yeah.
Your fucking money. A lot of it.
Yeah.
Because shit is expensive.
Yeah.
And if you don't got it, your life is going to be very, it's going to add more stress.
Right.
So, especially when you're young, so you have eighth graders, that means you're just about to start high school.
Mm.
Save all 4 years. Don't touch it.
Yeah.
Unless you absolutely have to, because once you get out there and you get a car and shit start falling off in your car, you got that shit fixed. I just got my oil changed. Niggas like, you need tires. I'm like, all right, cool. It's like $700. Then he was like, you got to get two filters. So basically the whole bill. Two filters in the car that I got to get changed out, and I got to get a rotation. Basically, Henry is like, yo, if you come back with us and get it done, it's like $1,500 that you got to spend.
No.
I was like, eat a dick, dog. I'm going to steal somebody's tires out the fucking and put the shit on myself. You can eat a dick, but I'm like, it can add up.
If this is really Grand Theft, you can go steal your fucking car.
Right? Like, give me a whole new whip.
Give me that.
And just paint that motherfucker.
I need this. Sorry.
Park it in my garage, and it's mine now.
Yes.
But life is expensive.
I blew so much money over bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Like when I first got out of school and I was making like $800 a week, I didn't know what the fuck to do with that
money.
Shit.
BMF, nigga, blowing money fast.
Yeah, man.
On nothing.
Yeah,
got nothing to show for it.
I got so many throwback jerseys that I don't wear no more, and those shits was like $300-$400 a pop.
You can still wear them though.
You can still, no.
Yeah, I mean, you
this
could.
This is the baggy era. They all 2, 3, 4X.
Oh, you fucked
I've
up.
I've never been a big nigga.
You fucked up.
I think the most I've ever weighed was like 210.
Well, give them the hash.
Hesh don't wear fucking jerseys.
I don't wear jerseys, nigga.
I can fake it.
I mean, hey, if you want me to have
them. Damn, that's the worst. You want some hardware jerseys? Clarewear classic jerseys? We can't fit them too big.
Yo, I was looking at clothes that I had. I found like 3X shirts, 4X shirts. I was like, dog, what the fuck was I thinking?
How fucked up is that? You bought that shit in high school?
That's the shit. When you get
influenced
by shit,
nigga.
Following people, you following people thinking, yo, this shit is the trend, this shit is it, but then you look back at yourself like, you look fucking stupid.
Yo, I was looking at pictures, woo!
Nigga.
Like, damn, that's mad denim.
Mad denim.
Yo, I still ain't gonna get over the fact that Cam had all y'all niggas wearing pink. All y'all niggas wearing pink. And if 2 years earlier niggas wearing pink, y'all would have fucking beat
all,
the shit
all types of
all
gays,
types of
all types of,
and then try to beat the shit out of nigga. And then Cam did it. All gay.
Yeah.
I got all pink, everything. Pink new rag, pink fucking Air Force with the white Air Force with the pink laces and all that shit.
Yeah.
Fucking
laughing at that to this day.
That's
how it be. That was like my boy, right? My boy Ernest. Shout out to Ernest. This nigga was always big and muscular, right? But he was like, he hanged around white people, so he was in the rock and roll and shit like that, right? This nigga used to come here with tight shirts, and niggas used to rank this nigga, clown him. Next thing you know,
everybody doing it.
This is Jim Jones. Everybody wearing tight shit.
Tight
shit. Like, damn, but y'all ripped this nigga for doing that.
Right. Stud, like, all the stud shit, all that shit.
Right.
Yeah, niggas corny. Yeah, so be yourself.
Niggas is followers. You know,
save money.
Sheepies.
Believe in yourself.
Yeah, treat people how they treat you. Yep. Don't be mean to nobody just because that's the a lot of the common things in school too. It was like they pick on somebody because everybody else is picking on them.
Yeah,
be nice to everybody, you know, because you never know, you know, who that person might grow up to be or like what may come of that person.
Not even that. Just be nice to people. It's the right thing to do.
Yeah, just be nice to people in general.
Just be nice.
But you know, it's I've had situations like that where it was like, yo, you the only one that never picked on me in school, or like you never talked bad about me in school, and now
I'm not gonna kill you.
yeah like some shit like that where it was like, yo, you was always like cool with me, you never really fuck with me like that. So you know,
my boy had
that goes a long way.
My boy had a thing about that. This is when we was going to the gym, my boy Mike, and we seen this dude. His name is Raul, but he looked like Stinky. He looked like Stinky from Hey Arnold. And we used to say that, and then he was like, yo, he did look like Stinky. I was like, damn. He's like, damn, I used to bug this nigga a lot. I was like, shit, just talk to him and say sorry. So he went to him. He was like, yo, man, I know. He just expressed like, yo, I know in high school, you know, I was picking on you and doing shit. Yo, I'm sorry about this. He's like, oh, no, it's cool. We was kids, blah, blah, blah. Come to find out, he works for like houses and shit, and he gets people Section 8. So he hooked them up, but this nigga changed his phone number, whatever. He said, yo, if I see your application, I'll hold it and I'll help you out. So, yeah. Coming full circle.
Yeah, it's just things like that. You know, you just never know.
Niggas was kids.
Was kids, but, you know, the people that's getting bullied don't really look at it as that. They're like, yo,
yeah, it's my whole life.
I hate myself. You know, they look at themselves as lesser than, or they never had no friends, or, you know, because these two people picked on me, this whole class picked on me, and now they fucked up for the yo, people carry that shit for like ever, my nigga. Like ever.
That shit, I ain't never gonna give up, nigga.
Like, yo, fuck these niggas for life. Yeah. If I see these niggas, I hope you're doing bad.
Right. Most of them do bad.
Some of them.
Shit.
A lot of them do bad.
The girls that you think is hot?
Because they peep.
My nigga.
They peep.
My nigga. When I tell you, like I said this before, I go on Facebook just to look at the bitches that didn't want to give me no play.
Yo.
Look at them now. They are all fucked up in the game.
They look like Pinky now.
They look, yo. You don't, we not.
You see how Pinky look?
You seen that new picture?
Yes. Yeah.
Damn, we're not going to do that, but.
I'm like, damn, Pinky.
No, we're not doing that, but.
You want to talk about a fall from grace?
Yeah, we're not doing that.
Yo, Pinky got us through a lot of hard times,
yeah,
right?
She did.
We ain't gonna act like that about Pinky, my nigga.
Got me on a lot of hard times.
Yo, we not gonna act like that about Pinky, my
nigga.
No,
we
she's
not.
A, she's, yeah. Yo, we just celebrate her during Black History Month.
Facts. Yeah. So that's what I'm saying. I'm not gonna disrespect Pinky on here.
Yeah.
Everybody, look,
even
I'm
though
fat.
Pinky look like a thumbnail.
We're not doing that. We're not disrespecting Pinky like that, dog.
Damn.
With the fucking perpetual tan lines. We're not gonna do that.
Yo. All the time.
It is what it is, man. But yeah, believe in yourself, you know.
Save money. Be the best person you can be.
Be a good person, you know. Don't take shit from nobody. Don't follow the crowds as much as you want to, as much as that's going to, I guess, make you popular or cool with that circle of friends. Do not follow the crowd. If you feel in your heart something is really bad or you shouldn't be doing it, don't fucking do it.
Get a hobby. Get a hobby that's probably creative.
Yeah, get one like that's going to keep you in shape.
Music, that too.
Get one that's going to keep you physically in shape. Mentally in shape, and it was another shape. I forgot. It was one
spiritually.
Spiritually. In like good shape.
Yeah, get your chakras right.
Yeah. So yeah, that's
just something that you can do that relaxes you. Just like these are things that I wish that I had done earlier in my life that I've fucking need now, but don't got.
Yeah.
Like, you know,
when
you don't want to be my age and realizing, oh, I fucked all the way up.
Yo, it's that whole thing of when you get older and you got to give advice to somebody, and it's always like,
hold on, I wish I would've.
It's like, be the person that you needed when you was younger type of thing. So it's like, you know, just exude that and try to be the best person that you can, and just, you know, just go through life and just be well.
Take risks.
Yeah, a lot of them, because you will die one day.
Take smart risks. Don't just jump off bridges and do dumb shit, but be willing to do something that makes you uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Be willing to try new
life
things.
Is mad fun outside your comfort zone, nigga.
And it's mad short.
Yes.
So talk
to that girl.
Yeah.
Do that thing that you want to do that you can't do. Learn that instrument. Learn that
go on
trade.
That trip,
you
do know, all that shit.
Go on that trip. Do all that fly shit.
Even if you gotta go by yourself.
Even if you go by.
Do stuff by yourself. Go to the movies by yourself. Eat food by yourself. It's not as awkward or fucking sad.
Oh, when I'm going on a trip next month, I'm going by myself.
Yeah, no, but you know, because I know a lot of people are like, oh, I can't go to, I'm not going to my movies. Like, no, go to the movies by yourself. I love going to the movies by myself.
Yeah, I love going to myself. Yeah.
I love going to the movies by myself. Fucking go out to eat by yourself. It's okay. It's like, nobody's really gonna care as much as you think they're gonna care. Yeah. Like, just do shit. Be okay. Be okay. Learn
don't
to be
worry
okay
about
with
other
yourself.
People's opinions.
Yeah.
Like, stop worrying about what people think of you and worry about what you think of you.
Yeah. Learn to be okay with yourself.
Because once you go home at night, you more than like you never gonna see them people again. And either or, like, you, they fucking opinion don't matter once you go to sleep at night. It's like, how do you feel about you at the end of the day?
Yeah.
That's all that matters.
Yeah, man. Do all that shit.
Yeah, man.
Good luck to you.
Yeah. Good luck to, everybody out there that needed to hear that. So on to reviews. Birds of Prey. What's your opinion on Birds of Prey?
So here's my thing. I liked the movie.
Okay.
I liked it. Okay. Isn't it the world's greatest movie? No.
Okay.
Is it the world's worst thing? Absolutely not. Anyone who says it is, they're fucking lying.
Mm-hmm.
All it is, though, basically, is just, it's fucking Deadpool with a vagina. That's it. It's
basically.
That's what it is. And whatever. So if you like Deadpool, you should theoretically like this movie. It's not quite the same type of jokes, but it's breaking the fourth wall, winking at the camera type of shit. And it's like the narrative, and it's like somebody who's super wacky and does off the wall shit.
Yeah.
It's fucking Deadpool. That's it.
Yeah.
Is it like the cartoon?
It's probably closer to the cartoon. But a little bit of the cartoon. Yeah, closer to it, a little bit of what I've seen in the cartoon. It's like that. She's just off the wall. She's on fucking Ace Chemical drugs. Nigga, she wild.
Yeah.
Ace Chemical drugs.
I liked all the characters.
I did.
Rosie Perez still got them thangs.
Yo, Rosie Perez still got them thangs.
Still got them thangs. I was like, I see you.
I appreciate that.
I appreciate that.
She's still on my hit list.
Yeah. She got them things. I liked the Huntress. Even though, out of all the characters, she probably had the least screen time.
Mm-hmm.
I like Black Canary.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, this is cool. I like. See, now this is how you, to me, is like how you set up the world, because if they decide to do a Birds of Prey movie without Harley Quinn, now you have some background. You saw these characters. You know who they are. And now here's their own movie. You get to do their own fucking thing.
Mm-hmm.
Now you get it. That's how you spin off a movie. If that ever happens, probably not. But I liked it. It was cool. It was funny. I genuinely had genuine laughs. I think Zaz is super creepy on purpose.
Zaz is always creepy.
Yeah, he's a fucking serial killer, psycho ass nigga. Ewan McGregor, I didn't love everything about him as Black Mask, but I get it. But he seemed like he was having fun doing the role and shit. So I was like, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a goofy, fun time. Everybody seemed to be like enjoying it. I liked the movie. I give it like a 7.5.
Seven and a half, eight. Oh, shit.
I liked it. I laughed. I think it got better in the second half of the film than the first half. The action was really good.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed the action.
Okay.
You did not.
I feel somewhat the opposite. So if I was a rated off rip, I would give it like a 5.5. I didn't really like it all that much. I feel like they tried to do too much within an hour and a half. Like, if you wanted to make this maybe 2 hours, 2.5 hours, and you wanted to give everybody an intricate backstory, cool. But y'all tried to fit way too much into a movie that was basically like an hour and a half, hour 40, something like that. The backstories took up most of the movie. They had to do a backstory for every plot. Had to have a backstory because they didn't introduce it in chronological order. So it was like, oh, they're trying to find this diamond, and I was like, okay, so why are they trying to find this diamond? Who's the diamond belong to? So now they got to go back fucking 40, 50 years to tell you, oh, who had the diamond? Why somebody's like looking for it? 15, what's inside the diamond?
It was like 15 years.
It was?
Yeah, it's literally.
Whatever. That's how much I wasn't paying attention. So, and then, you know, when a new person joins the group, or when like someone gets introduced, so now they got to introduce them. So it's like Huntress. Oh, what's Huntress' backstory? Why is she hunting niggas down with bows and arrows and shit?
But if you watch the whole movie, they sort of plot it out, and you kind of figure out who the fuck it is.
Like, but they don't tell, but I'm just saying, but they have to flashback and tell you who it is for the people that obviously don't get it. So now they flashback to who she is. And then they got a flashback on, you know, Rosie Perez and her backstory. Mm. Now they got to tell you why
Rosie Perez.
But they told you why she's in the position that she is who the captain is and all that shit. And then you got to go back with Harley Quinn's backstory. So I was like, all right, so this is how she became Harley Quinn. and all this shit. So that took up maybe a good half hour of the movie. Maybe like 20 minutes, half hour of the movie,
it was
whatever.
Like 5 minutes.
No, it was. When they did the fucking Huntress backstory, that was like 5 minutes. Harley Quinn backstory was like a good 10, 15 minutes. No?
Her shit was in the intro.
Yeah, that was like a good 10, 15 minutes. It when like it was like, the minutes. Intro was 10, 15 minutes. Then they got to an actual Harley Quinn story. And then it was like, oh, I'm bugging.
To me, yeah.
Okay.
Look, it's your opinion. If you didn't like the movie, you ain't like the movie. I ain't going to try to make you like the movie. That's fine.
It wasn't like, like you said, it wasn't the greatest thing in the world. It wasn't the most horrible thing in the world. But as far as like entertainment factor, it was cool. It had its moments. It doesn't deserve a sequel. I don't think I'll watch it again. I have to be like, there has to be nothing on me to watch this movie again.
Yeah, damn.
I
did not dislike it that much.
It had its moments, but it's, to me, don't waste your time. It's something that you can catch on like TV or DVD or something like that. I didn't really like enjoy it. A lot of the shit was just, it made no sense why it was there a lot of the times, a lot of the moments. So I didn't, I mean, the action was cool. The fight scenes was cool. It was really fun and innovative. Other than that, it didn't do anything for me. Like, the ending was very anticlimactic. Like, they killed Black Mask at the end.
What?
Yeah.
I mean, spoiler alert for that, I guess.
Sorry.
But why did...
They killed Black Mask at the end. They got the diamond back, sold it.
Blood diamond.
And then it was like, that's... So, y'all did all that to get the diamond and just run the fuck off.
Did
and
the
like,
mask get burned on his face?
No.
Oh, fuck that movie. Fuck that movie. That's the greatest thing about him.
No, so it's you know, they did all this shit where it was like they... It seemed like they set shit up just so they could have fight scenes and just so they can flip and have women kicking ass on screen.
So, I mean, well, fucking spoilers for the movie. So, the diamond belonged to fucking Huntress's family.
Yeah.
So, she got the money. So, now she's using that money to fund their fucking... Birds of prey fucking shit. That's what that's what it is. Because he died. They don't need to fucking burn it if he dead, nigga.
they just hit that nigga with a grenade and he blew up. That was like
kabooms.
That's whack.
That nigga went boom boom.
He went boom boom.
So he did the what is it? The kick ass shit.
Basically.
Yeah. And then nigga with the rocket launcher at the end of the shit.
Mm-hmm. That was it.
I thought it was a good movie. I enjoyed it.
Good is a stretch.
Okay, well,
for me.
Okay, like I said, 7.5. Maybe Nick.
I give it 5.5.
I don't think it's as that low, but that's my
opinion. So let's meet in the middle, nigga. 6.5.
Okay? All right, 6.5 then.
Cool.
Yeah, boom. Fuck it.
So they made Black Mask this comedic ass.
They made him this fair weather, going with the flow, you know, do what I say. And then he had his moments of being really stern.
He was menacing and crazy, but not all the time. He was like, more loose.
That's like if you made like a Joker movie, like with the actual DC villains, and Harvey Dent was some clown ass nigga.
He kind of was in the
They had some nods to
the Jim Carrey one,
to Suicide Squad and shit like that. You know, they had the shirt, the Daddy's Little Monster shirt, Daddy's Little Girl, whatever the fuck he said. They
Captain
had
Captain Boomerang poster.
Yeah, Captain Boomerang wanted poster.
She briefly mentioned it.
Yeah, she briefly mentioned it, and then like the whole thing is just like she's broken up from Joker, and it's like she's trying to gain her own identity, but nobody takes her seriously. Everybody wants to fuck her up and kill her, cause
like in the cartoon.
Yeah, no, but the cartoon is kind of like that, but it's not as like everybody wants to kill Harley Quinn now, because once you like, if you're attached to Joker, you have certain immunity.
Yeah,
so it's like
now he don't fuck with you.
Now that he don't fuck with you, you don't have that immunity no more. So it's like now we can fuck you up because we don't have this thing to worry about.
Right.
So if it gets a sequel, I'll be very very surprised.
Well, the numbers is low.
Yeah, from what I heard, the box office
lower
numbers
than
is really, really low.
Yeah, I don't know.
Opening weekend is like $25 million or some shit like that.
Yeah, I think the overall budget was like 84. I think it was only projected to make like 63 or 64 over the weekend, and I think it made somewhere around like 30.
Yeah, something like that.
Something like that, 32, 34.
Damn.
So there's a potential for it to make that money back. But I wouldn't call it a hit by any stretch of the imagination.
I mean,
unless word of mouth picks it up.
Weekend, then
yeah, but you know, if it has strong, really. But if it doesn't have, you know, big drop off rates next weekend, it might have a chance to make the money over its run. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't call it a hit, but it might make its money back, which might maybe allow them to do a sequel. But yeah, it's not looking good for it, which sucks because I thought the movie was okay.
Yeah, I mean, it was alright, but I love Margot Robbie as a Harley Quinn though.
Yeah, she's good. Yeah, I like Journey Smollett as
Journey Smollett was good in this as Black Canary. And that's another thing that fucking pissed me off. For the only person with powers in that fucking group, she used them one time.
And them things was dang. Well, because, but if you watch the movie and you pay attention, there's
don't give a fuck. You can't have powers and use powers one time.
But there's a reason behind it.
I know.
Yo, he got a thing with somebody using shit one time. He thinks the movie's trash.
Nigga, what the fuck is the point of introducing somebody where you have powers?
But there's
have powers.
But there's a reason why she doesn't do it.
He got a thing with somebody using something only once. He doesn't like the Hulk because he says Hulk smash once.
Once, yeah, I know.
Every time you hate something, it's because they use it once.
But this is an in-story reason.
Would you watch an X-Men movie if Cyclops did his optic blast one time in the movie? If Storm got a fucking hailstorm one time in the movie?
It depends on what the story is. If there's a story reason for it.
Like for Rogue, if it was Rogue not using her powers, then she finally just...
She touched him by it. Oh my God. She's stealing shit.
But if there's a story reason for it, right?
What was the story reason for her?
She told her fucking
time. She didn't.
Her mom died helping the police, being a hero.
Okay.
She did not want to do that. So she's actively trying to stay away from that kind of life. She did not want to do that.
They didn't set up a fight scene for her to fight more than like maybe two people at a time where she had to use her powers. But then in that final scene where it was like 18 of them niggas, so I was like, all right, I got to use my shit now.
Yeah. What the fuck? Okay, so she didn't need to use it, so she didn't use it. When she had to use it, when she needed to use it, she used it. And if you the story is following a specific timeline, so it's like these are the events of this fucking week. So maybe, you know, this week she didn't need to fucking use the powers until that fucking one moment. Like that.
All right, fam.
That I get it, but like there's a story reason why she didn't use the power. Like it's built into the story. Like it's not like she was just out here being a hero, doing hero shit, and then like she wasn't using it.
I'm just saying,
if she was out here stopping crime and all this shit she's doing, she was like, I'm just trying to be a singer in this fucking club, and then some fucking little girl that I fucking lives in my apartment got kidnapped. I'm trying to help her. That's it. And then fucking right. Oh shit, niggas came through with the fucking blickies. It's like, well, I don't want to die, so hoorah. And then fucking she used the shit. I don't know, nigga. That's the canary cry.
I can't even repeat that.
That nigga sound like Simba when he was trying to roar.
That's the canary cry.
Nah, but
yeah, nigga.
All right, man.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Still get a 5.5 out of me.
All right, 6.5. Here we go.
6.5 overall. Bobby, based off that, you think you're going to see it?
Not now, no.
I will, but I'm gonna be upset. Cause why? I don't know. I like Black Mask. Waste of a character.
Total waste of a character. Total waste of Margot Robbie.
But them things was thangin'.
Thanks.
So, now to review Power. Are we all on board? Did we all see Power?
Yeah.
What episode is this? Episode 16. Final season.
Oh, the sad one. This is what the episode felt like.
This is a very sad episode.
It wasn't sad.
It wasn't sad. No, it wasn't sad. It was
but
more
this
so.
Episode felt like this nigga singing. He's singing with his jaw.
That's what he is. I just come from the poorest part. Bright light, city life. I gotta make it. This is
where it goes now. So I just haven't come up. Skip right to the end. Do we
yeah,
play by
nothing, shot ghost? Yes, because nothing else in the episode matters.
Yeah, it doesn't.
So
nothing. None of it.
Lo and behold,
none of it.
Tariq shoots ghost.
We
Tariq
knew that.
Kills
the most
ghost.
Obvious shit, but I didn't think they were gonna do that.
Yeah, now we
because the ending I saw that was on Instagram, Tasha shot ghost.
Oh, okay.
So it was.
So they swapped it.
They swapped. I mean, they said that they shot a bunch of different endings. Yeah. So that's the one that they decided to go with. The one with Tasha, it was like she confronted Ghost at the club where I guess they had that whole plan where Tariq was supposed to meet her somewhere, and then like she was supposed to be in the truck. So she thought some other shit and then went upstairs and was like, had this exchange with Ghost, and then said, like, you're not gonna corrupt my son. And then shoots him, bang, and then you know, Ghost falls to the ground, and then he says a line that he doesn't say originally when he got shot and Tommy is holding him. Mm. He says, nah, let it go. Let it go. But now he says, let him go.
Yeah, he did.
Let him go.
Yeah.
And then Ghost dies, ultimately, by the hands of his son. So it's kind of like the story of Frankenstein and the monster, where it was like the thing that you created killed you.
But he didn't. Okay.
He did create Tariq.
I guess.
What do you mean you guess?
Did he?
Tariq created Tariq.
Yeah.
Tariq created Tariq. Mm-hmm. How?
Tariq's being a bitch. Because I will refuse to.
Look you dead in your eye.
I refuse. Refuse to. Okay, let me not. Let me walk this back.
He says, teach me the motherfucking game goals and teach him certain aspects of the game. And
he didn't teach him shit.
I mean, when is
and he didn't, and he was mad at the nigga because he didn't tell him he sold drugs.
Yeah, the reason's not justified.
It's so stupid. It's like, oh, I didn't tell my 14-year-old son that I do illegal shit and murder people. I'm a bad man.
I don't think he was more so mad at that. He was more so that the family broke up because he felt like, 'cause he left them for Angela. And then when you find out that you're cheating on my mom after we had this solid, perfect-ass family.
That's not what he was bitching about, for the most part. He brought the Angela shit, well, like, maybe twice. He was mad about the whole not talking about the drunk shit for like three seasons. I'm just telling you off of what they showed me.
Okay.
I'm just telling you off of what they showed me.
I don't get it.
Yeah. Fucking stupid.
So
I'm glad Tasha got the fuck she deserved. When I seen that show, I was like, oh, this bitch is dirty.
Yeah,
she sent homie to jail. She tried to send homie to jail. Homie was like, nah, I need an alibi. So he went to go buy some Skittles or some shit.
Yeah, with Red Bull.
Like Red Bull or some shit. He's like, yeah, I'm on camera in case this bitch tried to double cross me. Mm-hmm. So, I guess from jump, what happened at the beginning of the episode? So, man, what happened?
I don't know.
I don't know. I don't remember how it opened up. I don't even fucking remember.
But this is basically like the last episode. So it was a Tasha and a Tariq tie up.
Yeah.
And
wait, didn't he go to school and the teacher got arrested? And
So who snitched on the teacher to find out that day he had drugs and he was selling them?
I think he just got caught.
He might have just got caught.
He was dumb and white, so he just got caught.
Dumb and white.
So Tyreek's. So basically, this is what happened. Ghost gets shot. Tyreek, the nigga that shot that nigga. Mm. They go to the fucking nigga from Cosby Show to fucking check out the will and shit.
Yo, Ghost is the GOAT.
Yeah.
Didn't leave.
Even from death, nigga.
Said he didn't take pitch. He didn't leave Tasha nothing.
He didn't leave Tasha a fucking thing.
He left all his money to Raina, Tyreek, and the little baby that
don't have no money to just look at people all weird and shit.
And he paid the grandmother.
Yo, I look good on Blink, B.
Yeah, she don't.
She don't need to blink. She on screen for 2 seconds.
Yeah.
he paid the grandmother's rent for a year.
Fucking GOAT, nigga. Even in death, he the GOAT.
Yeah. That don't mean no.
So because Raina's dead, all her shares go to Tyreek.
So 2/3 of the shit go to Tyreek, but he got to go to school and he got to get a 4-year degree and have a 3.5 GPA
before he can get any of the money.
If he don't get that shit. So right now, he don't get a cent. He don't get nothing until he graduate college.
Oh, yeah. I'm definitely doing that shit, not that.
But so Tasha went to fucking the old white dude that tried to buy the club up season 2 or whatever. The fucking mm-hmm. showed up. It was like, if you get my son into school, we'll give you truth in exchange. So he's like, so basically.
Oh, yeah. Tariq gets truth and money.
Yeah, he gets everything. Yeah. So in exchange for the club, he gets him into his fucking alma mater school or whatever. So that's Tyreek's thing. When Tyreek shot Ghost, I think he gave Tasha the gun, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
She took the gun, whatever, and that fucking single dad nigga she was fucking that nigga, and she left the gun in his house, and she called the cops on that nigga and was like, oh, I think I know who killed James St. Patrick and whatever. The cops came to get that nigga, scooped him up, and they was like, oh, tell him I was with you, Tasha. Tell him I was with you, Tasha. She's like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. It's like, damn.
Damn, yeah. Bitch.
But then that didn't work out because apparently when they went to like question him and shit, it was like, had an alibi because I was in the store buying a fucking Red Bull at the time a Ghost got shot when I was with you. So it was like, oh, Tasha, you killed that nigga. And Tyreek was like, no, I can't let my mom go to jail. She's like, nah, just live your life.
Live your life.
Live your life. So basically it ends. Tasha go to jail for killing Ghost even though she didn't kill Ghost, and Tyreek gets to start a whole new life.
Okay.
And that's how it ends. And then apparently there's something that ended the episode that I didn't stay.
So y'all
watch.
Niggas didn't. So no, at the beginning of the episode, it clearly said, don't go nowhere.
Click.
Stick around.
Well, you click.
We got some shit
it.
To show you after click. The credits roll.
Click.
So what they showed is that there's going to be. So there's. Power got me fucked up. If they thinking I'm watching 4 more installments of this shit.
Wait,
so basically 4 more installments. So basically they broke Power down into like sections, right? Where it was like this first book.
Mm-hmm.
So they broke it down into chapters. So right, this first book is whatever. The second book is Ghost. And then there's 3 other books. Where it's like now is a whole new Power type of shit where it's they're going through Tariq, he's in school, mm-hmm. Tasha's in jail. Sax is still a cop. Now they introduce Method Man as somebody, and then they introduce Mary J. Blige as somebody. Now, y'all niggas, I might watch because Meth is my favorite actor, my favorite rapper ever. And now y'all got him in the show as an actor. I might watch this shit. Y'all might have me, but I don't know if Meth is enough to make me watch this shit again. And then they do this flashback of 1996. So they got like the story of Kanan. And then they got some shit where they go back to 1996 where Tommy, James, and Angela's in high school. Mm-hmm. And Tommy is played by Carl from Shameless.
Oh, word.
And he got braids and shit.
I'm with that. I might watch it now.
Ghost is played by some unknown black kid that I don't know. And then Angela played by some little Spanish girl that I don't know.
Yeah.
But it's just like, you know, it ends with Angela showing James brochure for a school choke that's in Connecticut.
Yeah, that's where she leaves, and that's why they break up, I believe.
Yeah, but they flash back to that, so I'm thinking, all right, so I'm guessing this is like the how Ghost became Ghost story, so it's going to go from 1996 until Ghost's death.
Yeah, it's
going
to show the moment where she left, and then he had to fucking live his life, and then he meets Tasha.
Yeah, then it's going to show like how Kanan raised them niggas on the streets and how they became who they became and shit like that. And it was just...
So they're going to have both these shows at the same time or is it one show?
I don't... Like I said, Power got me fucked up. If they think I'm watching all this shit. And then the hashtag is Power Never Ends. Oh, it's over for me, nigga. I'm done with the shit. I know who shot Ghost. I'm good. I'm done with the shit.
Plus, you know, I don't really like prequels like that. And then if I know he died by his son hand, why don't I watch with him do whatever the fuck he do?
I mean...
I know where he ends up. He ends up in the club and he sees the Spanish chick in the club. One day he's like, oh shit, you ruined my whole life. And then I die. And then it's over.
Yeah, but then like we know that. So it ends with, you know, Keisha's dead.
Yeah.
Tommy's with the Vatos in California now. Mm-hmm. Fucking Sax is a cop again. Fucking Han came back.
Yeah.
And that nigga's Han and everything now.
Yeah. I believe that's not the same
that's
actor.
That's the same actor. His name is John in this.
Okay.
Yeah. Same actor.
John, he's
back. I
want
to make sure
he
wasn't being racist.
Yeah, he just ain't
back.
Eating nuts. It's the same.
Yeah,
thing.
I want to
make sure he wasn't being
Tasha's
racist.
In jail, so I guess they're going to do some fake ass Orange is the New Black type shit. She took off that wig, nigga. Them braids?
You don't talk about her like that.
Love Notorious. She got nice breasts.
Did she pull the wig back like yeah.
That is also true.
Finish him.
So Tyreek is going to school now. He's going to I think the school's called Stansfield or something like that. Mm-hmm. So they're gonna chronicle him going through school or whatever. He graduates in 2025 or 2024. I'm not watching four more years of this shit. Y'all fucking out your mind. So that's basically the long and short of it. They was like the whole episode is them trying to find out how they can pin the deaths of certain people on other people and then not go to jail, and how Ghost was trying to get Tariq to confess to Raymond's murder, and how they was trying to, you know, have Ghost go to jail for Terry Silver's murder. And it was just nothing worked. So they just wind up killing Ghost. And then it's like, now without Ghost's testimony, we can't put a lot of this shit on people because he's dead. So, Tariq James St. Patrick is now a thing, and now we got to see what this new chapter of Power is that's supposed to be coming out in like fall 2020 or some shit like that.
I give it a shot. I watched like one episode, and
they've already taped the shit, so it's like,
yeah. So I watched one episode.
I think I'm done.
I think I watched.
You watch the shit and report.
Oh
back
no,
to
I'm
us.
Not. I'm just look at it.
Yeah, and just tell us like, is it worth watching? Because if it's the same writers, the same plots, the same bad acting, the same bullshit, I'm good.
I'm just trying to figure out if it's more than one show, I'm not doing it. If it's one show, but then it don't make sense that they're going to have present time shit, flashback shit. I don't want to do
so
that.
So what it seemed like they set up, they're going to do a Kanan story, they're going to do a Tommy story, they're going to, you know, do the shit with
it was a bunch
Tariq
of,
and Tasha. It's a bunch of different...
Like one-off type of shit?
Nigga, I don't... You had to watch the ending. I don't know.
I'm going to go home and watch it.
They just broke it off and said, yo, Power never ends. So I don't know how long they plan on doing this shit or what the fucking...
Because I'm not watching five seasons of Ghost shit and then five more seasons of Kanan
shit
and then
five more seasons
of
Chapter
2,
five more seasons of Chapter 3, five more seasons of Chapter 4. I'm done with all this shit.
I'm good.
This shit is out of my fucking system. I know who shot Ghost. I can put that shit to bed.
Get out of my system.
So, I'm good.
Yeah.
You good on this?
Yeah.
No more Power? We good on this, Bobby?
No more. I'm not
cool.
doing this. I'm not doing this
Boom.
To myself.
Take this shit off my computer.
You
know
I get a headache every time I watch this shit? I get yo.
It's so fucking stupid.
Or something. I don't know. Something happens with my body every time I watch this
shit. A hernia?
Something. Stomach hurt. My head hurt. My feet hurt. I don't want to watch this shit no more.
It's fucking pollution in your brain.
Hell
nigga.
Yeah, it is.
Toxic.
This shit is toxic, nigga. Oh, fuck. Let's go to the motherfucking topics and see what we got here. What's on this goddamn list?
God is over. Fuck.
No more power. So, Spiral trailer. This is from the Book of Saw.
Mm.
Starring Chris Rock, who is the executive producer, and also starring Samuel L. Jackson, the motherfucker.
Motherfuckers?
So, basically, this is a new age, new and improved Saw, but it's not the same Saw guy because he's dead. Well, it's somebody that's a copycat killer. I mean,
that didn't matter because he died like.
It came back alive.
Movie like three. And fucking was still. They were still sawing niggas like, for like eight.
The whole time has been like a copycat killer. So.
Yeah, he came back.
No, he didn't.
Yeah. He died and came. Yo, in one of these movies, he came back. I'm like, why the fuck is this nigga still alive?
He did not.
Unless it was a different time jump. No, it was like in the later ones. I think it was the last one.
It might have been a flashback.
He came back.
It might have been a flashback. He did not come back. I ain't watch it, so I'm taking your word for it. I'm just saying, mentally, I refuse to believe that nigga
I don't know. I don't know where the time jump is, but that nigga was there, and I was like, yo, he's supposed to be dead. Why is he here?
It's possible. Well, I do know that one of the movies, they had like a plot twist and where they like retroactively changed. Anyway.
This nigga has his whole neck cut off with a saw.
He should be dead.
Ironic.
That's what I'm saying. He should be dead.
Yeah. But, and he had cancer. That's a double whammy.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
Yeah.
But the Spiral trailer, how do we feel about it?
It looked all right.
I can't take Chris Rock seriously, man.
I don't think anybody can.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard to take Chris Rock. See, is that to his detriment, though? Like, is it hard for... I mean, Jamie Foxx did it. Is it really that hard to do? Or is it just that certain person?
He's not as talented as Jamie. I guess...
But I'm talking about the comedian that can be taken serious.
Well, with Jamie, he kind of, like, weaned himself into it. It ain't like he jumped face first into this shit. Did other movies leading
up
to this.
There's a difference between a wean and, like... It just ain't for you, dog. Chris Rock been acting since what? What was his first role? It wasn't.
But he ain't really.
I'm gonna get you
that
sucker.
Changed for 100. It probably is that.
I'm gonna get you sucker. That's what 86, 87,
something like that.
You been acting for what? Close to 30 years, my nigga.
But he really ain't been in that many movies though.
To be with serious roles.
Yeah.
Is that his fault?
I don't know. I'm just saying. Is he
typecasted?
It's a difference of saying like, oh, yo, you can't do it. It's like, nah, he didn't really do that many. Versus Jamie Foxx, he probably did a lot more. Have more time to hone that specific skill in dramatic roles. I think Chris, when he was doing movies, he leaned more towards
nigga,
comedy.
Jamie Foxx made Booty Call and did Ray.
Yeah.
The Range, nigga.
The Range?
Well, he did Bait, too.
But he's also.
Bait was kind of serious in comedy. Yeah.
He's also very talented motherfucker. What the fuck?
Remember Bait?
Oh, when he was trapped in a convenience store.
Yeah, hitting his face with a brick and they put that tracking meter in his face.
Oh, yeah. He was in that fucking convenience store in the desert and his girlfriend was, fuck, what was that lady's name?
That's like a combination because I think that was comedy plus dramatic stuff, right?
Yeah, you got to do
something. I mean, it wasn't
like that
dramatic. It was more a comedy movie with dramatics. Like serious elements. This movie is just like.
And he's fucking, and it's Jamie Foxx. He's talented as fuck. What you want me to do?
Yeah,
but I'm just, okay.
I can say, oh my God.
I'm just saying that, you know, for a comedian to be taken serious, it doesn't take.
That's my favorite thing in the whole world.
Yeah, it is.
That's so fucking funny.
What the fuck was
how you melodically sing that?
Man, I'm gonna make a meme. If Power think I'm watching all these specials, fuck you.
You see?
Fuck you. Fuck you.
See?
Yeah, I'm gonna do that I'm gonna do that for the page.
Do it for the culture.
I got that clip too.
Yeah,
shit.
See, for the culture, nigga.
We need more clips.
culture,
need to go viral.
That'll go viral because I ain't watching that shit.
But yeah, man. The trailer looked all right.
Yeah, it looked cool.
I'm not going to judge Chris Rock too early. Yeah.
I don't know. It depends on what his role in the movie actually is, right?
I mean, he seems like the main character. He seems like, you know, if he's the executive producer, I'm pretty sure he has something to do with the script as well. So he's going to write himself in certain roles and then he's going to, I mean, I don't know what his role is in the movie. Hopefully he is the main character. Hopefully this will change our perception of Chris Rock. Maybe if it's not in the acting aspect, maybe it's more in the, you know, executive producer aspect. It was like, oh, Chris Rock can put together a fucking decent movie.
Plus, I don't really give a fuck about Saul that much. Like, I'm not super precious about it, so I'll watch it and like.
I mean,
because
they have like fucking 12.
12 of them, yeah, I know. So I'm like, yeah, I'm like, so it's whatever. It's like, I'm going to watch this, and as long as niggas have removed body parts and get stuck in weird traps, I'm like, okay, it's a Saul movie.
Yeah.
Like this, I mean, like, I don't know. It's like, even if it's halfway decent, I'm like, yeah, cool, fuck it, whatever. Mm. Fucking Saul. Like, I wasn't expecting an Oscar worthy fucking movie.
Right.
You know what I mean?
All right. So let's see. A Fall from Grace got 26 million on Netflix in the first week.
Yeah, niggas love Tyler Perry.
26 million views. God damn.
Tyler Perry out here for these black women's.
Well, they
I mean, it's a lot of grandmas and aunts that like Tyler Perry still in his shit, but
I think it's more because of the, you know, the wigs fucking up and
you know what's fucked up? I forgot. We never talked about it. I did not know that was Macabre. I seen the picture. Mm-hmm. That wig is so bad that he turned into a whole new nigga. I looked at the picture. I see clip or like whatever. Somebody put a picture of the shit, whatever the fuck. And I was like, I don't know. That nigga looks weird. I don't know who the fuck it is. And then I think you put something in the group chat where he's like, show the L. And I was like, that's not that nigga. Isn't it? Is it? So then I Googled it to look and see. I was like, that's really that nigga. I'm like, yo, he looked like a whole different nigga. I was like, that's how bad that wig was.
For this movie to do 26 million views in the first, week?
Yeah.
I'm not hearing a lot of good reviews. I'm not hearing any reviews on this movie. It's not like the most talked about movie on like Facebook or Twitter or nothing like that. Do people just watch this shit for the bad production of it? Do the numbers, but does it matter at the end of the day? Because 26 million views is 26 million views. You can't take that away from me.
And there's some caveats to that.
Right.
First off, one, I think it was one of those movies. Maybe my algorithm is fucked up. It was one of those movies where they just pop it up like as soon as you turn on Netflix. It's like one of them things, so maybe that gave me more people reason to click on it,
right?
And then Netflix now changed the way that they count what a view is.
Oh, okay.
They changed it because I think before you had to watch like 75% of the fucking thing.
Damn, bro.
Yeah. Ooh. It was like 75% of
what
it
is it now?
I think like 3 seconds. Like,
damn.
Really?
As long as you like,
click the movie?
As long as you click on it and like let it play for, I swear it's something dumb way shorter than whatever it used to be. Like, they literally just did that maybe like a couple of weeks.
Nigga,
three weeks ago.
Like a fucking music stream. If you listen to 30 seconds of the song, you listen to the song, and it counts as a stream.
Yeah, so they definitely changed the way that they count the views. So that could be just niggas click, oh shit, what the fuck, my bad, and back up. Oh, counts as a view.
Tyler Perry, what? Yeah. Fuck out of here.
Counts as a view.
Netflix logo.
Yeah.
Yeah, fucking Netflix logo.
So I don't, and again, I'm not to discredit the movie or whatever, but I'm saying some of that could factor.
No, discredit it.
Yeah, all that.
Yeah. Some of that could factor into what those
I've seen most of the movie on fucking Instagram and Twitter just off the fact that it's so fucking bad. The nigga that was drinking air water.
I don't know what that is.
The bad wigs.
Air water.
The nigga, so, you know, so they got this scene where they're in a diner, and I guess somebody is supposed to be drinking, like the extra is supposed to be drinking something, but there's nothing in the cup. He's acting his ass off with nothing in his cup.
Extra, like.
But we can see nothing's in the cup.
Oh, shit, lit.
So, it's, I don't know, man. I respect it's just it. Tyler Perry just.
You gotta stick to the craft, man.
I guess. They paying me.
Dedication, nigga.
Me, dig old grandpa. He there.
Dig old grandpa.
So, yeah. Shout out to Tyler Perry.
That's Tyler Perry. Mark Sinclair hinted. Mark Sinclair hinted that Fast and Furious.
Imagine gonna ilk that nigga name.
Mark Sinclair hinted that Fast and Furious 10 could be split into 2-part movie. Yo, Mark, get the fuck out of here with this shit, man.
Just like Harry Potter. I respect
It's like Power, my nigga. He doing the Power shit where it was like, yo, the fucking season finale was supposed to come last year, but no, y'all want to waste more of our time and have this shit end in fucking February? Leave us the fuck alone. Make this shit one movie. We don't need part one and part two.
They need two films to tell a complete
story. I do
story.
Not need 4 hours of Cars and Mark and all this shit
and John
telling
Cena,
me
God,
and
it.
John Cena again.
You don't know what you need until you see it.
You are 100% right, because this shit could, you know, exactly. Be like a nice little date movie, or it's like, shut the kids up. Let's go see some fucking cars blow up with explosions and helicopters and dinosaurs. I'm pretty sure they're going to have dinosaurs in this
dinosaurs.
One.
Dinosaurs. Nigga, going back to
here's
the past.
Please.
If this next movie makes a good amount of money, I want them to make 2 movies. I want them to do it.
Why?
They deserve it. They made it.
I need them to incorporate something else.
They made it to 10, my nigga. They shouldn't have made it this far, but they did. Let them just go out with a bang. Let them go out with a bang.
Something.
I forgot about those. I forgot niggas used to do that shit.
Yeah, I need them to incorporate dinosaurs. Dragons.
Rhythm
spoons.
Rhythm spoons.
Something.
This is
Pokemon.
This is
something.
Yo, this is literally like some Tropic Thunder shit. You remember with what was it? Scorcher.
Oh, the Scorcher.
He's like, who let the fridge open? It's basically that.
Yo, nigga, you could
do
anything. This has to be made into a universe at this point.
Well, maybe not that. Maybe they should just do the 10. Make 10 into 2 movies.
They're gonna be in space, nigga.
And then Doctor Doom. I need Doctor Doom in 10.
No, just or
Doctor Doom.
I need something.
Or just tell a complete
Darth Vader.
Or just,
I need Vader.
Or just end it.
Derek Jeter. Somebody.
He gonna be a Darth Vader, gonna be the TIE fighter. Dom gonna be driving his car. He's like, the force is strong with this one. You ready?
Or just end it.
Time to go turbo.
and say, hey,
and
look.
Again.
But hey, look, we did a cool thing.
Anything, nigga.
Ended at 10.
Godzilla gonna be this shit. Fuck, watch.
Yes.
It's gonna be fucking.
We need your help, dog.
Ready Player One Part Two of the Fast and Furious.
Yes. Yep. Easy E.
Easy
Ninja Turtles. Something. I need something for Fast and Furious. Sonic. Put Sonic.
Yeah, they'll go with Sonic. You wanna race?
Dom spends the whole movie trying to be Sonic. He's trying to build a car fast enough to be Sonic. Right. He's trying to make it as light as possible to be Sonic. And then he finds out he can't be Sonic. Then he goes insane, goes into an asylum. Joker's there. Mm. I don't know, nigga.
Y'all niggas is haters. Shout out to Fast and Furious.
He's just doing too much.
It's not. He's just like, hey, we're going to do number 10 and we might be
how
two.
How many? If Ja Rule doesn't come. Ja Rule.
Ja Rule.
Monica.
I need him back.
Nah,
he ain't doing shit.
He was throwing festivals. Like, he too busy.
Shit, you could have took Tyrese's spot.
Yeah.
Nah, Tyrese's still there.
Nah, he all right.
Yo, if they don't have Tyrese on a fucking souped up bus by the end of this shit, they have to have
on a bus
in the back of the bus and
with a Sprite, with a Sprite.
Letty has to be driving. He has to be in the back of the bus drinking a Pepsi, singing "Sweet Lady." Please, they have not used that. How you gonna have all this nigga?
That thing I'm okay with. That part.
This nigga swung a fucking Corvette.
Yeah.
With Letty in the car, and she's looking like, we about to die in this bitch. Across a canyon.
Yeah.
Yo, Sweet Lady, back of the bus, Pepsi. I need all the endorsements.
Oh, Pepsi, that's what it was.
And surprise. Then it turned into a magic school bus. I don't know what the magic fuck happened.
Miss Frizzle.
And then it goes back in the time.
Miss Frizzle.
I don't know.
Miss Frizzle?
I need something to happen. Yo, other than what the fuck is happening now.
Who's the Facts of Life bitch? Who's that?
That's
basically who that was, right?
The Flashing Light bitch.
The facts of Life.
Oh, Facts of Life?
Who was that? Damn,
what's
that name?
Bitch. Why he was just doing this?
Oh, because she had big titties.
Somebody had some things.
Yeah,
she had some things. She had some big titties.
Facts of Life?
Yeah, the Facts of Life.
Oh,
yeah.
What Trudy.
Nah.
The black chick?
Nah, the teacher.
Miss redheaded lady?
Yeah.
She had the things?
Yeah, she had the things.
I don't know about that one.
Mm-hmm.
Sure you wasn't on Pornhub, nigga?
Was sure you wasn't on Watching Cocks of Life or something? Like, what the fuck?
Cocks of Life.
Magic School Bust.
Right?
Magic School Bust.
Kind of thing.
Magic School Bust.
Come on the Magic School, get it?
Magic School Bust. Come on the Magic School Bust.
Sure you wasn't just watching Bang Bust, nigga?
Probably. Yeah. You want to ride? All right.
What are you in Miami just picking up? Miss Valerie Frizzle.
You had the things? I don't think she had the things. You had the things? You must have thinking of something different. That's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. I was like,
nah, you nasty.
Because I miss, yeah.
That was all that nigga night. My bad.
No. Facts of Life, though. That's Magic School Bus. He's talking about Facts of Life.
Oh.
Because she looks like that person.
Facts of Life. You talking about Regine?
Yeah.
That's what I said, Trudy.
Trudy.
That's what I said, the black chick. He said, nah, the white one.
Fuck with the chick name.
Kim Fields.
Yeah, Kim Fields.
Miss Garrett? I know you're not talking about Miss Garrett.
Maybe.
No, are you nasty?
Oh, you nasty.
Bobby's the nastiest of niggas if you talk about Miss Garrett. And I respect it. But
shout out to Kim Fields and her fucking bloodline.
Mm-hmm.
Like, all her sisters fine.
Who's sisters?
Yeah, we're not doing this.
Yeah, this is definitely not Miss Garrett.
Do this shit later.
Gary did not have the thing.
So Disney may cut 20th Century releases to 4 movies a year and refocus on Disney Plus and Hulu content.
That makes sense. They gotta focus.
Yeah, nigga.
That's what I thought you was talking about.
That's what I thought.
That's why I said Trudy. Or Tootie. Tootie, that's what it is. Tootie. But she not white. She
Bobby, stop being nasty. We got a show to do.
Or you can take it to be nasty.
Save the link. Go back to it later. We almost done.
She do got the vibe. All right.
Focus, niggas.
Oh, I'm focused. All right.
What do y'all think about Disney and Hulu content and Disney Plus content refocusing? Not on titties.
it makes sense. They got to control how the amount of movies they put out a year. So it makes sense if they'll dial that down to maybe 4 releases plus whatever they do for their Disney releases and to do whatever other content they wanted to do on Disney Plus. Because people's number one, like I was just talking to my friend like 2 weeks ago and he's like, I'm about to cancel Disney Plus because there's nothing up there. No new content.
Well, it's coming now.
It's getting ready, but it's not out yet.
That nigga's impatient like a motherfucker.
Yeah,
I mean, look, I'm just telling you, like,
don't you got the bundle?
But you're paying money for something, and if you don't,
there's stuff on there. You just don't want to watch it.
Right? Yeah, it's all the old shit.
No, there's a difference between there's nothing on there and it's just shit that I don't want to watch.
But that's
pretty much the same
Disney
thing.
Got what? It's fucking 80, 90 how many times worth of content on there?
How many times I'm supposed to watch fucking Bambi mom get shot in the face like, blah?
My nigga, you got all the fucking Disney cartoons. You can watch Goof Troop, Darkwing Duck, fucking Tailspin.
You got smart guys.
Chippendales, Rescue Rangers.
So what happens if you went through all that already?
You got no fucking life. Do something else with your life, nigga.
Right?
The fuck you go through all that content already? And they just... When the shit came out, they put fucking Lady and the Tramp. They got the Jeff Goldblum shit. Yeah. They got all this other shit. They got the fucking not, Toy Story shit.
But if you're not in a Disney movie like that?
Then why the fuck you get Disney Plus?
Right. Mandalorian?
Nigga, borrow somebody's shit.
I don't know, nigga. I'm just telling you.
And just get the bundles. Ain't watch ESPN. I'll be killing UFC.
If there's shit up there that you don't, if just because there's stuff on there.
So you telling me you bought something for one thing? That's fucking stupid. Right.
No, maybe you brought something and then you found out that it wasn't. Maybe there was nothing that you actually really wanted to watch like that.
Stupid.
That's just stupid ass for stupid.
Stupid.
Don't call my friend stupid, nigga.
They stupid.
Don't call my friend stupid.
All right, I'm sorry. They made a stupid choice. They not stupid. Do your research. Yo, what up? You scared of you no more, Debo.
I'm just saying, whatever. If you fucking, it's like, fuck, you get Netflix, you get Netflix, but then you're like, I don't really want to watch.
That's fucking stupid. That's like buying an album for the single you heard and the rest of the album whack. Right? How the fuck you buy the album then? Buy the single.
I'm returning this. Fuck this.
That's not a good analogy.
It is for me in my head.
It's a horrible analogy. It's like, oh, I really like this song. I'm going to buy everything.
I'm going to buy the whole album.
Yes, because
why
I like...
Why would you buy the whole album?
Because I like the song and this artist...
So buy the song.
But what if the artist has... What if the artist has more songs that I like?
You just said it ain't no more shit on it that you like.
But you didn't know that until you brought the album.
Whose fault is that? So you telling me you why jumped into something without doing your research?
I'm not bugging, right?
Do your Googles.
Huh? I'm not bugging, right? Like you like.
They told you from Rip what was going to be on the site.
Yeah, oh, no,
did they not?
I'm talking about the music thing now. You gotta be fucked up with the album. Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying. So the whole thing of playing a single was to get everybody to buy the album. The rest of the album could be shit.
Yes,
but we're gonna give you this to make you think the rest of the project is actually good, or you're gonna get maybe 12 or 15 more of these things.
How is that my
fault? If they show you something, be like, hey, we got the Mandalorian, we putting this on here and that on here, and then you just listen to and you just watch those, and then the rest of the everything is shit on there.
Yeah,
whose fault is that?
Theirs.
Who, the person that bought it or Disney?
Disney!
Disney did their fucking job. They sold you something.
And to be fair, they had a schedule for everything.
We are arguing that you feel like you're getting gypped on what you paid for.
I don't know if that's the right word.
To say I'm canceling something because there's nothing on there.
That I want to watch.
Thousands of hours of shit on there.
Listen to the part that I want to watch.
Whose fault is that?
They have a lineup of everything.
Because they gave you, WandaVision. They gave you all this shit. They didn't say when that shit was coming out. So the fucking shit dropped and it's like, oh, it's not coming till such and such date. Okay, cool. I'm still gonna buy this service because Mandalorian's on there. So you bought this shit for one it's just one original program on that shit that you want
to
watch.
And I don't even know that's why they brought it. I just said the Mandalorian because that's the first thing that popped my head. I don't even know they brought it because of Mandalorian. They brought it because it was a thing was coming out when Disney's putting on something, they want to check it out. I'm saying for trying something, realizing that they didn't like what it was servicing and decided not to continue to pay for it.
Eventually come.
Then I'll pick it back up. It don't hurt nobody.
It don't. Do that then.
Okay. Cool. Goddamn. You got fucking mad aggressive about it. I'm like, damn.
I wasn't yelling at you. I was talking about your friend.
I know.
I was yelling past you.
Damn. Like, I don't know. It's like, you can't be mad at somebody for like picking up something, thinking that they was going to enjoy it, and then not enjoying it, and be like, okay,
but
I'm not going to spend my money on it.
Somebody tell you who the fuck they are, and then when, like, I told you what I was going to do. I showed you what was on this shit.
Yeah,
that's because it wasn't everything that you wanted.
And maybe, okay, but maybe they thought at first that they'd be okay with what was up there, and then it was like, nah, I don't really like all this.
And then how much are you really fucking paying?
That's not the fucking point. It's your money.
You're right.
And it's your money. If you're spending it on something and you don't like it, you are free to fucking cancel it, and it's not the world's big of a deal. It's not a big deal.
Stop being so fucking impulsive.
It's not impulsive to try something.
So in Loki and WandaVision and fucking Captain America.
Right, and guess what? They'll take my money right back and I'll have the service the same fucking day.
You's a bitch. Keep that shit.
Little bitch.
Dog. What the fuck?
You just like them niggas like, power's going. I ain't watching this shit no more. Cancel my stars.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Why is it a problem for you?
I'm just saying, it's just
like I got something for what I wanted, and then now that I don't want it anymore, like why would I continue spending money on something that I'm not gonna use?
I can see if it was just like nothing's ever coming to this service again. It was like, but they have don't they have like a stipulation on how many times you can like stop and restart your account type of shit? No. You can suspend your account at any time and just pick it back up.
Why would they stop you from giving them money?
I don't know.
I don't understand why you said that. Why is that such a weird thing to you? Like, I tried something, I didn't like it, and I decided not to do it anymore. Yeah, like I don't know why that's so weird for you.
Not weird. It's just, you know.
That's like with everything. That's like life. You see something like, oh, I think I might want to try it. You try it out, you find out you don't like it, then you move on.
Okay. But some you can't take back. It's not everything.
I think you can take back a streaming service, dog.
I mean, try to buy a game from fucking GameStop and bring it back because you don't like it.
But you get $8 for that shit. You can do that.
Yeah,
well,
but within like a certain amount of time.
Yeah. Well, did you
do that shit with what's the Anthem? Anthem?
No, because I brought it digitally.
Oh yeah, you're right.
But okay, you gotta do that. So yeah, I'm not saying that some in general now you can do that and there aren't consequences to that. Yeah, but in terms of I thought I would like this, so I decided to try this, and
I'm
then
cool
I don't like
I'm
it.
Wrong. I wasn't right.
Yeah.
However you want to word it, cool.
Yeah, I just feel like it's not, it's like,
I'm okay.
You can try stuff and not like it.
You can't.
It's okay to try stuff and not like it and then decide not to do it anymore.
All right.
That's how most people figure out they don't want to do certain stuff. They try it and don't like it and then they move on.
So Lucasfilm's president Kathleen Kennedy confirmed Indiana Jones 5 is in active development with Harrison Ford.
Yeah. No. This nigga loves playing Indiana Jones more than Han Solo.
Yeah, he definitely does.
So, but that's his bread and butter because we know we're gonna go see an Indiana Jones movie.
I don't know about that.
I mean, some people may. You're not everybody.
Yeah.
A lot of white people like Indiana Jones.
No, I like Indiana Jones. I'm just saying the last one wasn't quite it, Chief. Mm-hmm.
Was that the one with
the aliens
Shia LaBeouf?
And Shia LaBeouf and fucking monkeys?
People like that shit.
They filmed that shit in Connecticut too.
Yeah, they went to
downtown Yale.
Yeah. Some
been
people
in that shit like that.
Yeah.
They didn't have black people alive in that time.
Wait, hold up.
We weren't allowed to be people.
What is the time?
Like 1950s or 60s?
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it is. Around
there somewhere. Yeah, that's why that nigga's wearing the greaser jacket with the fucking A-haircut. A-haircut.
Oh, man. So, fucking Indiana Jones. So, Elijah Wood is interested in reviving the Nightmare on Elm Street with Robert Englund back as Freddy.
I mean, I like the idea of it because they got Robert Englund coming back, but I mean,
nobody's going to pay Freddy.
Not rebooting everything.
Oh, so now we on board with no reboots. So when I was saying that shit 5 months ago, I was like, let them do reboots.
I don't understand why they will reboot bad shit. Like shit that was really bad that could have been good. It's like, yo, if you'd have done it this way, it'd
because
been
we gotta take oh, you know a, gotta take a shot on a sure thing.
Yeah, that's what. That's,
is it,
that's,
is it really
that's
sure?
Because
a
it's
lot of shit
more,
is
more sure than the bad shit if you try to reboot it.
You know that there's at least a slight built-in audience for Nightmare on Elm Street.
Yeah.
Because people like that.
That's all nostalgia.
Yeah.
So
it is cheap to make.
Yeah.
Apparently. It can be.
Let's see. Friends reunion to have a 1 hour unscripted special on HBO Max.
I care nothing of this. I've never actually watched this show.
I've watched Friends.
I think I've seen clips. I think I've seen clips of it, but I've never actually I don't think I've ever sat down beginning to end.
Maybe once or twice.
Yeah.
And I couldn't get through a whole episode. Yeah, I don't see the appeal of this shit.
Yeah.
But homie that played Ross, he made a comment recently talking about he wanted a Friends reboot with a more diverse cast, be it like an all black cast or all Asian cast or whatever.
Can't be mad at him.
And then it was like, hold up, nigga, you know y'all know y'all bitch y'all shit from Living Single, right?
Well, he didn't.
So Maxine Shaw, what the fuck is her name? I'm not gonna call her Maxine Shaw.
Because she has a real name. That's
Because she has a real fucking name.
Yeah, but everybody knows who you talk about.
I just want to call her. I think her name is Erica Alexander.
Yeah.
So she went on Twitter and said, "Hey, nigga, don't fucking bite the hand that feeds you, nigga. Even though y'all was more successful, we came first. Y'all bit that blueprint from us, and then he came back with some extra white shit. Like, well, if my comment was taken, well, this is not verbatim, but it was like, well, if my comment was taken out of context, you know how these interviews do, where they just chop and put shit where they want to put it. And I'm sorry if I misspoke or didn't know
we
that
pulled the gale.
What's the, whatchamacallit came first, but you know.
Do you really think that he knew about Living
it's
Single?
There's no way in hell that
there is a way in hell.
There is, but I would
a literal
I would,
way in
but
hell.
I would put it more on there is no way in hell that you began a show and you have no idea about this other show that has
no
the same premise.
He's just an actor who got hired to do a job.
So you telling me nobody was in his ear the whole time he was on Friends? Like, yo, you know, there's another show like that with an all black cast.
It's quite Queen Latifah. If you're talking about how popular Friends was versus how not necessarily advertly popular the Living Single,
you know what that's
was,
like? That's like
he might not have.
You know what that's like? That's like
bite my shit and not know where you bit it from.
Yeah, that's like
he didn't bite it.
It's kind of not like the same thing, but that's like Saturday Night Live not knowing about Mad TV.
Yeah, like how do you not know about them?
I don't know, because there's a lot of TV shows. I'm not saying,
but the exact same premise, like these, it's six friends trying to navigate their lives with relationships, work, and you know, regular life shit.
That'd be like if Will Ferrell came out.
It's the exact same shit.
Yeah, if Will Ferrell came out, I'd be like, hey, I wish we had something like Saturday Night Live that had a more diverse cast.
So you know about every TV show that's on TV at all times?
No, but I know if I see something that looks like something I've seen before, like, but what if he never, very reminiscent of.
But what if he, and again, I'm only talking specifically to him, not the people who ran the show, not the people who made the show, not the people
who. I will bring up the tweets, but it'll take too long.
I don't know what he said.
Gotten that ass.
I mean, yeah,
I'm
not saying that she's just incorrect. I'm just saying he might not have ever known about the show. He's white and not watching. He might not know about black shows.
White shit.
That's like asking him if he knows about Finding Mary Jane. He might not know about that.
That's after his time.
But I'm just saying,
this is on prime television.
It's a white dude doing white stuff in a fucking black movie somewhere. I'm saying he might not have never heard of it. I'm not saying that he didn't 100%. I'm just not going to automatically super kill him because I don't know that he fucking heard of.
Like I said, if I had time, I would bring up the tweets, but, you know.
Yeah.
Eric Alexander got in that ass. Like, nigga, don't fucking act like.
Yeah, I be seeing.
Don't act like, nigga.
And he didn't make the show.
No, I don't give a fuck. You don't act like.
Okay, well, fuck. Mm-hmm. I mean, and also he trying to get Living Single back.
No, he not.
Well, a Black Friends, nigga, that's the same, you know, right? If he stole that,
he said, he told the writers of Friends that he wanted to date more diverse women in the show. He wanted to date Asians and blacks and all that shit.
He's the only nigga who dated interracial on that show. He's the only one who did it, I think, because I think Alicia Taylor was on that show, right?
Yeah.
So I mean,
Gabrielle Union, I think.
So I don't know why you trying to attack the nigga for trying his best. Maybe it was a good shot. He could be. I have no idea, but, you know, I got to take it off what I see.
Yeah, Living Single came out first.
I don't know if that means a lot.
I'm pretty sure the execs did.
It doesn't necessarily mean.
The execs definitely 100% bit that shit. It's like, hey, we're going to do the same shit, but with white people. Yeah.
Okay, but that's not what I'm saying. I'm talking about him specifically.
Yeah, you're talking about him specifically.
What was that all-white group that bit off of, New Edition?
What, New Kids on the Block?
New Kids on the Block.
Was it them? Them white kids saying like black kids? They was like, yo, this is what. I think Bobby Brown talked about that shit. He was like, yo, if y'all were a white group, y'all blow up.
If it ain't New Kids on the Block, I don't know.
I think it probably is New Kids on the Block.
Yeah. Again, I'm not saying that he did or did. I'm just saying it's possible that he didn't. No. And again, and he didn't make the show. He just was like, saw a casting call for a show and was like, oh, cool, I want to get it. And then he got it and now he's on the show.
Right.
So it's not like he himself was the one who fucking purposely ripped off. And Let Me Single, it was the executives. Now, if you're talking about the executives and the showrunners and all the people in charge of that shit, they probably definitely ripped off a Living Single. But you can't, I don't want to like throw that all on him because he's just an actor on the show. He just got a job.
All right. So, on to some gaming shit. Nintendo attempted to get Sora from Kingdom Hearts into Smash Brothers, but was denied.
And you walk away, you're not going to be in this game.
That could have been big, but what do you think Nintendo's reasoning is?
To make Kingdom Hearts 3.1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Basically.
Until they come out with 4. I'm highly disappointed at 3, though.
You know Disney is Disney.
Yeah,
so
but
you know
Disney,
I mean?
That's kind of... Don't they have other Disney characters in Smash? Or no?
No.
I don't think so. No.
I think Sora is more of a Square Enix character, right?
They got Cloud in
it. It depends.
Yeah, right? Square Enix.
Yeah, but that's not... But he was created... Specifically for this Kingdom Hearts world, Cloud was made.
So well, there's no
Final
joint
Fantasy.
Custody of the motherfucker? Square Enix and Disney don't have a hand on it?
I feel like Disney probably has more control over that. That's just how I feel, but I could be wrong.
Okay, whatever.
You might be right, because they said nope.
Yeah. So obviously they got some final. So obviously they got some type of say on it, and I was assuming because it was their, that's probably something they...
Fuck that
find
shit.
The rights
put Seth Roth in that shit.
Seth Roth.
Or put the black guy with the fucking... The goddamn Mohawk, Mr. T. that was Mr. T.
Who, Barrett?
Yeah, that's Mr. T. Barrett's
he didn't
Mr.
have
T.
a Mohawk, did he?
Nah, he had a high top fade.
Something like it.
Oh, yeah, that's what I thought.
That was Mr. T. Come on, Cloud.
That's Mr. T.
Come
gun
on,
head.
Cloud.
Come on, Cloud.
Smoke crack, don't you?
Don't you? I pity the fool with my gun hand.
Give me the sword.
Let's see. Evo 2020 to bring back Marvel vs. Capcom 2 and Mortal Kombat 11 has been removed. So now, how do we feel about that shit?
I feel nothing.
Do you
feel nothing? I hate Mortal Kombat so good.
Always. Dang. So, do you think that talks to more... do you think that talks to more of the popularity of Marvel vs. Capcom 2 or, I guess, just the not-so-favorable fanfare of Mortal Kombat 11?
Well, yeah, because wasn't when Kaiba was here, weren't y'all talking about how the controls felt weird in that or felt different?
Yeah, it's just so a lot more combo based, and you have to know how to play in order to actually like do some shit. You can't just button mash and just be good at it.
So maybe a lot of people felt that the controls weren't quite
what
they wanted.
If you're going
to
Evo, I'm pretty sure if you got somebody like Sonic Fox or some shit like that, that nigga's fucking god at that shit. Yeah.
I don't know. Or maybe they just like to rotate. I don't know. I don't really watch all the whole lot of
rotate,
Evo.
But Marvel's Capcom 2 has been a game that people have been championing for, you know, what? When did that shit come out? '04?
Marvel's Capcom 2?
2?
2? No, this is what...
That shit came out on Dreamcast.
Dreamcast.
Yeah.
And wasn't that 03? 04?
Something like that. Around there.
06? Something? I don't know.
Yeah, probably like 02, because I feel like we was playing that shit in high school.
Yeah, we was.
Yeah. Because I remember Jason used to play that shit, so it'd be like 02.
Let's see.
I'll take you for a ride.
Dan Houser, who co-founded Rockstar Games with brother Sam, is leaving.
Yeah, I don't know what that's about, but that's kind of a big deal because he was like the writer, one of the main writers. He wrote
Bully,
Red Dead, Bully.
Damn, he wrote Bully.
Yeah, he wrote Bully, Red Dead,
Grand Theft Five. Yeah.
Yo, Rockstar don't get no fucking props they need. Yo, they came with Mash. You remember Midnight Club?
No, they get all the props. They get all the money and all the props.
It's only because of like mostly Grand Theft Auto shit, but Bully was a really good game.
there's supposed to be a Bully too, but I don't know what happened to that.
They keep alluding to it.
Every person I ever see talk about Bully says it's fucking really great. Like like all the games, like well, I wouldn't say all the games, but a majority of the games are really, I think, appreciates it. I just don't know.
That's something I gotta do before I die. I gotta get the last achievement in Bully. Because it's pissing me off to see that fucking 99% on my Xbox achievement shit.
What, you got the scholarship edition?
Nah.
Oh, you ain't get the one, the remastered one?
Nah, I think I had it from Gamefly and I sent it back.
That was a long time ago.
It's
like
$10
but it was like, now.
I mean, yeah, I could buy it. I might stream that shit and just be like, huzzah!
Huzzah!
I got it!
Huzzah! Yeah, you got it. Yo, I'm going to get you. Yo, you got to beat that fucking pig on Diddy Kong Racing.
Please. Yo, you gotta beat the- next No Smoke, so, I need to do that. Yo, please. I need to emulate it. I got to beat this fucking pig. I got to do it for me and my boy J-Rock, yo. I got to do it for us, my nigga. I got to do it.
You're still supposed to bring in the PSVR, too.
Oh yeah. You're supposed to play Resident Evil.
Yeah.
You gonna play it though?
Yeah, play it.
Okay.
What the fuck?
Okay, cool.
Yeah, man.
Don't die on us.
Yeah,
man. that voice is like, no.
Yeah,
like,
I know.
Very reluctant.
Yeah, I still ain't go up the steps. that game's scary as fuck, man. I quit.
Yeah, get on my face, nigga. Activision revealed Call of Duty Modern Warfare experienced double-digit percentage growth from in-game spending over Black Ops 4 due to no loot boxes.
Yep, people just buying just to buy.
Okay.
Yeah, so that shows you that you don't need loot boxes to make your money.
Yeah. Right.
And they're coming out with some crazy-looking skins. They got motherfuckers with full masks on, suits and shit.
I think people would be more
my army or two.
Yeah, I think the people would be more willing to spend the money if they know exactly what they're spending the money on.
Yeah,
versus getting a random box that might give you a random thing.
Cause I spent some cash.
Yeah, because you wanted this specific thing. It's like, I'll spend.
Like, oh, I want that nigga,
and I'll spend a fucking $3, however much it fucking costs for it, and there you go.
Yeah,
instead of spending $5, I'm like, I might get a gun that I like. No, it's fucking stupid.
And Call of Duty Modern Warfare is really good. I played the special ops mostly, and they keep adding missions.
Yeah,
it started off with like 5 missions or 6 or something like that. Now they got like 9, 10. I can't get the black nigga because I gotta beat all the missions, and them shits is hard as fuck. So they keep adding shit, so it's making it harder for me.
Gotta unlock the black man in Black History Month.
Yeah, right.
I think it should be free, or like at least like,
free for the month.
Yeah, free for the month.
Should be emancipated.
That's a double entendre.
Should be emancipated.
Should be free.
Should be emancipated for the month.
Give us up.
Give us free. let's see. Xbox boss Phil Spencer says Microsoft sees Amazon and Google as competition. Google, I don't know why. Not Nintendo and Sony. Explain that to me.
Stadia streaming.
Yeah. Stadia is garbage. Yeah. But it's going nowhere.
But they have money and they have a streaming infrastructure.
Okay.
And PlayStation and Nintendo don't have those. Mm-hmm. Xbox has that. That's why. And he thinks that's the future.
Okay, so he's not in competition with Nintendo or Sony, but Nintendo and Sony are beating Microsoft by a long shot when it comes to gaming consoles. So now you're more worried about the streaming company.
So you're talking. So I mean, it's
is that Apple's, two different points?
Yeah, I think it's two different points. Okay. It's not apples and oranges, because one is just console sales. Mm-hmm. It sold more consoles, but they don't have a service like Game Pass. Game Pass could be making them, who knows how much money, more money than Xbox or Nintendo.
Clutch, nigga.
Yeah. Nintendo's online service is $20 for a year. And fucking Game Pass, if you get Game Pass Ultimate, it's $15 a month times however many fucking people have that. And that works for PC and Xbox. So they could be making money over fist.
You know what it's coming to? Games about to be a subscription service, nigga.
Yes.
You're going to pay like fucking $90, $100 for all these games.
Yes. That seeming, which is why he's saying,
oh man,
which is why to him, why to him,
capitalism,
Stadia is, or
next 10 years,
Merc, Google is more of a competition to them than PlayStation, because that's basically the future we're heading towards.
If they can get Stadia right,
but I'm saying, but so you wouldn't spend $90 a year fucking and just have all the games you want to play and just play them like you do it and not think about it?
Because I would
$90 a year.
$90 a year. I barely play the games that I've actually bought for like 60. Shit, I bought fucking 2K for 100 and something. I barely play that shit. I'm not paying $90.
So for the price of 2K,
I don't play games that often.
But I'm saying for the price of 2K that you're willing to pay and you don't play games very often, for actually cheaper than 2K.
I think for the
you
amount
get
of time
all the games.
I think for the amount of time I actually play video games on my Xbox, and the $90 a year, I think I'll personally pass.
I don't know. It's like, I don't know. When I do the math, is that like $12 a month or some shit like that?
You maybe. $12, I think $13 a month. I'm good on that.
They might do some
We're
shit.
We're not there yet, but I think
it's coming, though.
That's where we're going.
They're going to end up having some shit that you buy Xbox TV with the with the processor in it.
Which is why
it runs fast.
Which is why they...
I can play games on my TV, but I never tried it.
Yeah, this is why they named the Xbox what they named. It's Xbox Series X, but it could be, but they're trying to make a Xbox ecosystem versus like the next console. So it could be like Xbox Series Q or whatever the fuck the next thing, like whatever, like whatever the fuck they end up calling it. That's what their naming convention is. Like, they're trying to make an ecosystem. They're trying to make it like you're just buying into the Xbox brand as a whole, not just this one console. That's their thing. So that's why to them, they're more competition.
Damn. Yeah. Will this?
I don't know.
I'm trying to think, like, if this did work, right?
Mm-hmm.
What's the future for PlayStation if they don't do it?
I don't know, but that's why they teamed. That's what we talked about a few months ago. They teamed up.
Oh yeah, they
Xbox
did team up.
Because they don't have a streaming infrastructure.
I forgot about that. They're trying to do that shit together.
Yeah, so they too see that this is a potential future, but they don't have the money or the infrastructure to make their own. But Amazon, Google, all that shit. That's why he sees them as competition, because they have Jeff Bezos' money, nigga.
Yeah.
So he's like, that's their competition going forward to them. Yes, they like to sell consoles, but software sales is where the money at, or the streaming, or a fucking streaming service thing is where their money's gonna really be at. Yes, obviously, I'm sure they would still want to sell fucking consoles. Don't get me wrong. They definitely want to sell consoles.
You're trying to make consoles the dinosaur? Damn.
I mean, it's gonna be eventually.
Okay, so kids. Sony is apparently waiting to see the price of the Xbox Series X before determining the price of the PS5.
That's
some petty
up,
shit. That's some petty fucking shit.
So they can try to undercut it.
Yeah.
But did we ever get confirmation if there was going to be two SKUs on Xbox?
What you mean? With two different
like versions?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think so.
A stronger version and a weaker version?
I think that, I think they did confirm that. Because I think from the price point I saw, I saw one at like, huh?
There's no price point.
I could have swore I saw one where it was like the less powerful one is going to be like $4.99, and then like the Series X is $5.99. I don't know how true that was. I saw that a long time ago.
Yeah, I don't.
It was like an estimate, or it was like, you know, for the power and like the capability. What it could,
could
be.
Plans probably changed.
Hell yeah.
I only brought that up because to me, so even if they try to undercut Xbox, it might not matter if they have two SKUs. They'll have the high performance one, and people go in and know, I'm going to spend this amount of money for high performance one, and they'll have the lower performance one. Will probably be either equal to what PlayStation will try to undercut them to, or maybe even cheaper. Right. So, like, it might not hurt Xbox if they do try to, like, undercut them like that. That's the only reason why I brought that up.
That's kind of fucked up, dude.
That's business, nigga.
Yeah, I know, but goddamn. Goddamn, you pull out of E3, you like, fuck it. Like, let them have it. You know, they reveal their price or whatever. All right, this is ours.
And to be fair, there's only probably a varying scale of range where that PlayStation is going to drop.
Yeah.
So, they're like, they might undercut them, but it's probably not going to be by a lot. Yeah. Because it's, I'm sure because they still want to be able to make some money off of the consoles too. Yeah. So they're not gonna be like, oh, Xbox is $400. We're gonna sell a PlayStation for $200. It's not gonna be that low. You know, like, they're not gonna cut it like that.
You know, people are really picking about a release date to this shit.
Well, yeah, because they want to know when it's coming out.
But you know when it's coming out.
You don't know the
November.
Well, but you don't know the exact date.
No, it'll probably come out like October. So it was like all
October,
right,
November.
So, yeah, so it's like, you know, the people that actually do have the money and aren't kids can buy it. Then it was like, hey, the Christmas rush is coming. So it's like, you know,
yeah. Yeah, just look at the track of the last.
Yeah, you know the
it's always November.
Yeah. You know the release month, but you want to.
Them niggas say fall. Date. They mean like October, November, the cusp of winter.
Like, you should just shave your shit now. Right? You got like 10 months.
Yeah, definitely. Start saving your money now so
get you a sugar mama.
Or that too.
Yeah, start jiggling.
This boy, old lady at this bar yesterday, walling.
Yeah. Go on fucking Reddit.
I seen a nigga look like Ric Flair.
Scooped her.
What?
Huh?
What are you talking about in here, bro?
Nothing. I saw some old lady at this bar last night. A young nigga, I think some young nigga scooped her.
Dang.
Good.
Yeah, I was like, oh.
PS5 secured, nigga.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Slow clapped it as that nigga walked out. I was like, I see you, dog. Dish?
Sometimes you gotta get granny drunk and be like, hey, you know.
Granny was drunk, nigga.
You got these loans.
give me your gumma.
She would give her a gumma.
So, on to some DC Marvel news. So, Joker supposedly has has a new girlfriend in the DC comics. Her name is Punchline. So, it's an Asian woman.
All shit diverse.
And I'm trying to figure out why these chicks be going for this clown nigga all the time.
Something about crazy. You know, chicks like crazy niggas.
Yeah.
I want to know how crazy she is, because she seems to be more cutthroat than Harley. Yeah. And I want to see that dynamic in the actual comic book. I want to know if that's actually going to bleed over into the animated series of Harley Quinn, because that shit is, like I said, that's a good fucking show. If that happens, I could see a rivalry.
Do you think the character is going to stay around long, or is it going to be like a stunt thing and she's disappearing?
I hope so.
I got to read the comic. I got to see development.
Yeah, with,
if she's just there for just like, hey, I met some girl. She cool. I'm going to take you under my wing. Well, you my girl now. She actually has like lines and a personality and shit. So.
Reviewing it?
Huh?
Reviewing it? I don't think it's out yet.
But we can review the comics before, because she was in a cover to one of the comics where it was like they had this mysterious girl in the background, but they didn't reveal who she was.
Wow. Yeah.
It's in this new comic that she's coming out as Joker's girlfriend. So I guess we can like review that. We can read that one, and then when this shit come out, I guess we can review it. I don't know. Right. We'll think of something. Right. Who knows? A lot of shit. Since we ain't got power no more. Let's do something.
Oh,
do an actual comic book. Whew. We don't do those often. Yeah. So
anime, manga.
Yeah. So let's see.
Psych.
Manga's out of here.
You don't want to do manga?
No, I'm just saying we don't.
You want to read the new Death Note? It's like one shot.
I mean, we can.
I mean, we can.
We can read that. I'm just saying we just generally don't talk about that shit. That's why I was laughing.
Yeah.
Commentary by Carl. Yeah,
exactly.
I'm
going to
start doing it. That's one of the things.
Yeah, we got to start doing it. So, Lakeith Stanfield wants to make Joker movie with the Safdie brothers. He's just weird enough to pull it off, but...
I'm okay with it, but we just got the Joaquin thing.
Thing, and then I think it's going to be too many jokes. Like, we just got a black president, so I don't think we could do a black Joker yet. The white people still have to recover from that blow.
So, wait, that's more believable, a black president, than a fucking black Joker?
At this point, yes. Mm. Because we've been talking about switching races of every character possible, so if we take one of the most popular, if not the most popular villain in DC and turn him black.
To a necro.
There are going to be so many blackjack jokes. There are going to be so many.
He should just be blackjack. Fuck it.
I mean, but you can't just take a character like Joker and repurpose him like that.
I mean, you definitely can.
You can, but it's not. I don't think that'll bode well.
Because he don't really have a real. I mean, he doesn't have like a real, real background.
He doesn't.
But, he's just a crazy nigga in palm paint.
Right.
That's like me being a hypocrite again. Like, if I support this, it's like, damn. Like, you. If you're going to do that and the character ends up being good, you might as well just make a whole fucking character, a whole different one. That's like...
Again, if you're asking me what I would prefer, just make a whole new character, but am I upset if they make him black? No.
Like, I'm not mad, but you know.
Like, what's the dude, Black Manta's son? He's Aqualad now. What's his name?
Oh, Calderon?
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about? Yeah, I don't like that he's Aqualad. Aqualad. You already had an Aqualad. Like, you ain't have to make him Aqualad.
Don't they name all the motherfuckers Aqualad?
But he's Aqualad.
No,
he was Aqualad.
It's him and the original dude.
Yeah, but he was...
He didn't have to be Aqualad, is what I'm saying. Like, could have been his whole different character.
Yeah, but Aqualad is just like a code. I think the other Aqualad existed, right? And he just took over? It's not like they got rid of the other nigga. He just took over the mantle of it. It's just weird to me. I don't know if it's quite the same as like.
It's kind of like how I feel about
making Peter Parker black. Like it's it's a little different.
It's like how you got Green Arrow and then you have Arsenal.
Yeah,
it's like that. They do the same thing, but one is different than the other.
Let's see. Kraven the Hunter movie spinoff where he hunts Spider-Man has reached casting phase. Okay. So, do we think it'll actually get to the other stage of actually like you know scripts and shit like that?
It's looking like it.
Sure, why not?
I have no idea. I
mean, we got a Morbius movie coming, so why the fuck would they not do a Kraven movie? And you know they're trying to build their universe.
And now I'm trying to think, how long are they gonna keep up this Spider-Man as a bad guy? If Kraven's gonna hunt him,
the next movie.
Because Kraven's not really a bad guy.
I feel like he tried to kill that nigga. And that makes
yeah,
him
he
a
did.
Bad guy.
Because it was something Spider-Man did. Spider-Man was wanted. Remember J. Jonah Jameson pull out that shit to make Spider-Man the enemy, and then everybody was after him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, then maybe that's what this movie will be about.
It might be.
All right.
I don't know when we get another Spider-Man movie. That's a good question. I don't know.
Next year?
Is it coming out next year?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think it's coming out that soon.
Well, because you got Venom.
Far From Home just came
out. Is Venom coming out this year, right?
I don't know. I don't think.
I've seen it. Like late this. Are they filming already?
No, I don't think they even started filming yet.
Hold up.
So Spider-Man director Sam Raimi in talks to direct Doctor Strange in Multiverse of Madness.
Yeah, because Scott Derrickson left and seems like he's going to come and replace him. Which is cool because without Sam Raimi, we wouldn't have Marvel, like the modern comic book movie as we have it now.
Mm.
It's cool to have him come into this fold of this new shit.
Okay.
Can't hate on it.
Yeah, not like Sam Raimi.
Yeah. All right. So, picks, man.
Ay, coño.
What we got?
My pick. I was watching videos on YouTube and I forgot about this nigga Kane Carter, Hot Damn I Rock.
Oh, yeah.
Watch his shit, but watch his older stuff because he went through a whole lot of shit and
the newest stuff
which I'm happy for him if that's his fine way to find peace and shit, but the content is vastly different.
Serious.
So yeah.
Serious.
Watch the other shit. It's just him doing dumb videos on the internet and it's funny.
My pick is Netflix's Who Killed Malcolm X.
Yeah, I meant to watch.
I was watching that over the weekend and I think I got one more episode to go. I think it's 5 episodes. They're about 40 minutes each, I want to say. So it's not that long. You can watch it all in one shot. But very, very detailed, very, very interesting. It's very dope. And Malcolm X is a hard ass name. Like, I don't know, that's just a hard name. Just X. Bobby, man, what's your pick, man?
I was watching BoJack Horseman.
Told you about that.
That shit funny.
Hell yeah.
I gotta start watching that shit because that shit is getting like rave reviews.
It is.
It's on like a 6th season or some shit like that. Yeah, they got renewed for some new seasons.
No, it just finished.
It just finished?
Yeah, it's final. It's done.
Just came up.
Oh, it's done like forever?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh shit, I'm about to watch that shit.
Yeah, then. And it's about an alcoholic horse who has mental issues and they talk about depression and anxiety and all that kind
of
shit.
That's why you like it. Okay.
Yeah, speaks to me, nigga.
Speaks to me, nigga. Okay,
yeah, sorry. Watch it. Nah, but they do a really good.
He was a stand-up comedian. He undercut his boy because they was kicking his boy out being a writer. Yeah. So they kicked his boy out. BoJack Horseman ended up being basically a failure. And then this motherfucker got a big ass house, but he got cancer.
Yeah,
the dude that
I mean, there's a whole lot. The show's really good and it's funny and it's stupid, but it also has really serious moments and it touches that shit really good.
All right, bet.
Yeah.
All right. So anything else?
No, I think that's it.
All right. So Ninja Vanish.
Yeah.
We out of here.
You